Here we go. A merry Friday Eve.
Friday Eve.
Hello.
And I have a message for you, Friday Eve.
Not the day.
Satan's trying to mess with me today, this morning.
Yeah, what's going on?
Overcoming tiny adversities over here.
Yeah.
I feel like this is every day with you now. Every morning you're overcoming adversities.
Well, what are you doing to help?
You have a tough life. I'm here to listen.
Fred,
but is this harder on a Friday Eve?
Yes.
Or Friday?
I don't know. No, it can be any day. That doesn't matter. It's sort of like it's never a good time when someone calls a meeting. You always say, God, this is the worst possible
Why
day
not
in
do
time.
It this day?
It's always the worst possible day in time. I'm missing my desk. My desk is gone.
Oh yeah. That was partly my fault. A little bit.
Your fault?
Yeah.
Do tell.
Well, I mean, I don't know. What'd you got first?
You said you're missing your desk.
So Zach has.
I understand where this is going, though, because Fred was a naughty boy as a child. There was lots of mischief in his life. So you got in trouble a lot with your parents.
Mm-hmm.
And I believe this is one of those situations where your dad says, so. And you're trying to figure out exactly what he knows versus what you did before you confess to things that you don't necessarily need to confess to.
Right. And a lot of times I talked way too soon or way too quickly before knowing what he knew. So I confessed to a lot of things that I didn't even need to.
What's the deal with the desk, though?
I've become Fred's dad. Good morning, by the way. It's the Mornin' Thang. Monica, Zach, Freddie Mac broadcasting live on your K92 Mornin' Thang. There is a drawer that's usually underneath this table right here that houses all 247 of my keyboards.
Uh-huh.
This drawer does not seem to be here today.
It's one of those roll-out keyboard placement ones.
It did break yesterday during KT's show, but we tried to work it out and fix it.
So y'all knew about this.
Yeah, but it breaks all the time. I thought it was fixed.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, Monica witnessed.
I was trying to fix it myself.
It breaking. Right.
And it was right there trying to, you know, get the drawer to get back on track.
Align back on the track so it can wheel in and out. You can push
your
pull it.
Yeah, yeah, y'all knew about this?
Monica
you didn't give me a heads up?
Well, I witnessed. I was holding the dang thing trying to put it back on track. And we're looking at Fred saying, Fred, get over here. Help us with it.
This happened during KT's show. So after 10 o'clock yesterday morning, I went over. I fixed it. I put the thing back on the tracks. Monica witnessed. And later, maybe 30 to 45 minutes later, I broke it again.
What did you do?
It fell off again.
Did it fall off because of you, or was it because of someone else trying to slide it out?
Well, it fell off completely because of me. I was trying to slide out the keyboard thing so that I could type something into the computer, and it completely broke, fell all the way off on both tracks. So there was no fixing it.
So you really did break it.
Sort of. It really started like 2 years ago, though.
I don't care who broke it.
We need a new one anyway.
Y'all don't tell me.
We need a new one, right. So that one's been there.
Side.
I learned from the engineers yesterday who are going to fix it today that it's been there since like 2003. So it's long overdue.
Okay.
That's all.
They're going to fix it today?
They told me they were going to fix it.
Okay.
They just said today.
That's the stuff I love, and most people don't necessarily have to deal with this at work. You have to deal with all these equipment, and sometimes I come in, and something we very much need is broken, and the response is usually, all right, cool. Why isn't it fixed?
We're going to get to it.
Well, we'll do it when we can. It's like, no, but I need it. You know what I'm going to start doing around here? I'm going to go around to people's offices. I'm going to just start taking their desks. First thing in the morning, I'm going to say, I'm not going to give them a heads up. They're going to come in. Their desk is going to be gone. And computer monitor, just something.
What's that going to do?
It's going to make me feel better. That's all that matters.
No, it's just going to prolong the problem.
I'm going to make everyone feel better with $1,000 at... What time? 7 a.m. in the mind reader. I don't know what the window of opportunity is because my keyboards are all over the place.
Very, very close. My computer isn't working this morning, if that makes you feel any better.
See, and that was just beeping a minute ago, so that would explain probably what the beep was.
Yeah, well, the window is closed the last time I checked it, and very, very close window there.
I think we're talking three or four numbers. Mm-hmm. Good morning to y'all. Text 52353. What you got going on? Do you have a tiny adversity you're overcoming this morning? Did you forget to, like, set your coffee pot or... one of those mamma jammas or the robots out to get you. Mm-hmm. Hit us up on the K92 Mornin' Thang Facebook Live video feed while it's still up.
Don't say
who knows?
That's next.
You never know.
What's next
in the hot list?
Okay, so I'm a hater. I'm mad with them, so I'm going to keep talking about them. That's John Cena and Nikki Bella.
I figured
what's
you'd
going
be
on?
On
yes,
that one,
I'm so irritated. But okay, and I have something in common with Kim Kardashian, and it's not bad. We'll talk in the hot list.
Yeah, I don't know. That thing started beeping like it was counting down to explode a minute ago. There's like a tiny little box underneath, and it was making all these weird noises.
Is it? Are we on? Or is that just muted?
Oh. Some fucking.
Is it in manual?
Yeah, but I hit the button. Jesus. Huh?
His computer.
Yeah, but there's like a little, there's these like connector things because the, you know, because it's 9,000 miles away, so it plugs into these little boxes that relay it again, and those relays, I think that's what was beeping. Mm. I don't know what it's doing. I don't know the solution. All right. Good. I hope every engineer has an off-air alarm that woke them all up here a second ago when I couldn't start the radio station.
Okay. Another one clip. Kim Kanye.
Do I have clips?
Yep.
I don't see him. Five number window. Good morning to the, you know, the three of you that Facebook algorithms allow to actually access this web feed. So, hi, good morning. I'm not bitter or anything. Good morning, Gerard, Anthony. Hey, hey.
Okay, I am such a hater, I know, but I was a lover of John Cena.
You loved John Cena.
I did.
You were definitely a fan. Sweetheart. Personality and just all that. And yeah. His whole relationship drama thing, you are furious with him this whole time.
I'm mad with him because he was pouring his heart out, you know, talking about his fiance, Nikki Bella, and how she destroyed him and she, you know, she postponed the wedding and said everything is done. It's a wrap until we figure out things. And I'm like, okay, well, he's going to move on and say, I'm done with her.
No.
But no, now he's back in the picture. Things are going well. What they say, I guess I should be happy for that. Things are going well for he and that girl.
It just seems like he's making every concession in his life.
Yes.
Because he's desperate.
She wants a child, so he's going to get a reverse vasectomy. I don't know a lot of details about vasectomies, but I've heard that the reverse is a lot worse than the the initial vasectomy, right?
Well, I can give you, let me see if I can give you the least painful possible description of the vasectomy. Let's just say there's a, think of it as a straw. There's a straw, okay? And what they do is they take a little, you know,
solder.
Laser, little solder, something like that, and they just slice the straw.
Yep.
And so then, you know, whatever liquids were going into the straw of the beverage you were drinking, now they don't go in there anymore. That's how it works. So now, to do the reverse, you got to go back in. Mm-hmm. You got to undo all of the cauterizing and things that you've done and then try to rebuild the straw.
Well, have you ever tried? It.
We'll put it this way. Have you ever tried to, if a straw is broken, have you ever tried to fix it?
Nope. Never.
It's very difficult.
It's very difficult to fix that straw.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, she wants a baby, so he's going to do it for the love of his life.
It just, it concerns me that he's giving up so many things that you have to think he's going to eventually harbor resentment down the road.
That's a possibility.
Anytime something goes wrong. I mean, what if she decides, I'm going to leave you now? Or, you know, just... Yeah.
Well, it's all for the show, right?
And that's the other thing is Monica thinks she's being duped by wrestling. This whole thing is just a storyline, and
it
she doesn't know.
It is a storyline. Oh, they're so, this is all for Total Divas to, you know, to pull in some viewers.
I'll tell you this much. If he gets the reverse vasectomy live in the ring at SummerSlam, then you know we've been duped.
Yep.
Yeah. And Triple H is the one giving it to
him. Oh, this water. Okay. All right. So moving on to Kim Kardashian and Kanye. We have something in common.
What's that?
And it's not bad. Their kids, they have chores.
She has like a chore chart that she has to make her bed. She has, you know, there's so many things that she has to do if she wants to get something. So she doesn't really get a whole lot of stuff like you would think.
Hmm.
It's one of the bribery charts. That's not a real chore chart. It's not one where they're responsible for it all the time. This is one where, if you want ice cream, you have to get 27 stickers.
I'm surprised they're having the kids do anything, though. Kim Kardashian, I guess Kanye, I feel like Kanye was the one that pushed for it. It's like they have to work a little bit. They have to do something. But
I've tried to do the chore chart in the past, and I got to be honest, it's kind of a chore for me, and I don't even enjoy that. Paying attention to the chart, having to put it together, becomes more work just trying to force them to do the work in the first place.
I don't think there's anything wrong with that.
What?
I mean, once
chart?
You finally get through all the frustrations of putting it together and having the chore chart and keeping up with it. I mean, they need to learn you earn everything in life.
True.
You know? I mean, they have everything they want, and they will continue to have
My rule is that you have everything that you need, a little of what you want. You don't get everything. But
you get nothing.
You have to work.
You get
but
air.
Ava, she had dishes. She had her chores were to put away laundry and take care of the dishes.
Yeah.
She's like, I don't want to, but you know, you're going to. Yeah.
My kids are lazy.
You need
they don't do anything.
Huh?
My kids are lazy.
You need to start doing that chore chart again. Or have Monica come over like
I don't want to do the chore chart. That's work. I don't want to do work. $1,000 in the mind reader at 7 o'clock.
That's easy work.
It's a 5-number window.
Mm-hmm.
It is?
Very easy.
Parenting is an easy work?
No. I'm talking about the mind reader.
Oh, the mind reader.
Yes.
Okay.
If you've been paying attention to the guesses, that's easy work.
Congratulations, Fred. You've saved your life right there. There you go.
What?
It's a 5-number window. If you go to the K92 radio app, all the previous guesses are there, so that it is easy. You know the 5 numbers and what's going down at 7 o'clock next show within the show. Just an adorkable hookup or hang-up yesterday.
Oh, they were cute.
I can best describe this, and it's not an insult, because it's a fact. We put two doofuses together and let them talk to each other for 60 seconds. We'll call it Chelsea and the 60-foot man. That is next on your K92 Morning Thing. What'd you say? Did you try? Yeah, see, again, because I don't know if this relay thing might be down, because it was beeping. I mean, it was like, burp, 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 burp. There's like a little... Right, no, I know.
Anything happen? This box right here was making noise.
Yeah.
And I don't know what that means. It used to have a green light on it when it was making noise. Now it does not. Now it just has a red light on it. I tried unplugging it for a second and plugging it back in. So I guess go try that computer one more time. But...
keyboard's in my way. Oh, this one's like just stored underneath. Like, yeah, sure, no problem. I'll reach down here under the table to type on that. But it's not long. It's not long enough to go any further than just balance
hey,
right on the end.
Anything yet? Nothing. Oh, hold on. There's something.
If there's something, that means it's working.
Yep. It went black for a second. I imagine it's just warming up. Let's get ready.
If you saw something on the screen.
It flashed. Yeah, so it should be good. I'm hoping.
Working.
Yeah, it's just getting itself.
Yeah, started. Gerard, I know it's 6 a.m., but back before Facebook death.
Actually, that means that it should be.
We'd even start with like 20 or 30 people right off the bat and then get up to like 40, 50-ish. Now we live in like the 6 to 10 world now.
I guess. Hold on, because now it's just like, how long should it take for this?
No,
yeah, because there's nothing now. Yeah, now it's just nothing. What the hell?
I don't know.
What the hell is going on? Because it just looked like it was getting ready to be on. Yeah.
Time, some of this relay is screwed up.
Yeah, now it's just back to nothing.
Get back here.
Yeah. Yeah, you can come on back in. Okay.
They'll get to it when they're done with the wide orbit upgrade 3 months from now. Aye, aye, aye. Overcoming tiny adversities here on the K92 Mornin Thang. Text 52353. There's somebody woke up this morning, their jaw won't close all the way, and therefore I can only eat my bagel with my front teeth like a chipmunk.
What's going on with that? You got lockjaw.
How does that happen?
I don't know.
That's what I wonder. You wonder sometimes just about, it can be about your body or just the world in general. What happens in the middle of the night sometimes? Mm-hmm. Like, what is going on?
Yeah, it's kind of scary with our bodies. I mean, they're amazing. But at the same time, you're like, oh my gosh, what if I get stuck with like my finger is frozen and I can't do it, you know, do anything for the rest of my life. Ah, but like my nephew Dwayne, he went to bed, woke up with the hiccups, and he had hiccups for, it was a day and a half straight.
A day and a half.
And he was like, he was going to go to the doctor to see what's happening with his body. Cause he was drinking water, doing a little, you know, blowing a bag or, you know, taking the air, whatever. And he said that, it would not go away.
Hmm. Well, you know what? I don't know if he tried what is considered the number one way to get rid of hiccups, which I actually ironically have coming up in Factor Bullcrap.
Oh,
I don't
have
know if he tried this. Yeah.
Okay.
This is remedy. Scientifically proven the best way to get rid of hiccups. Something tells me your nephew Dwayne did not try this, though.
Okay. Well, I bet you I'm going to wake him up and tell him to listen.
We'll just call it a very invasive procedure. Let's just we'll call it that for now. And 6:45, you can tune in to find out all the details. We were talking about when things break at work and then the people who are supposed to fix them just don't or just take a long time, whatever.
Here's
the text.
I don't get it.
52353 on the text. When a truck needs to be fixed at our work, the mechanic will schedule it. You show up at the time he sets, and then he tells you, I'm too busy to fix your issue right now.
Yeah, what's that about?
Oh, too busy. Why are you here?
We scheduled this. That's what the schedule's for. You know what I mean? You schedule. You put it on the calendar. Yeah. That means you block off everything else.
That's what
I
want. And this is what a lot of people want, is you're always dealing with somebody who says, oh, I'm really busy with dot, dot, dot. I want to be the dot, dot, dot one of these times. I want them to be like, well, I'm really busy with Zach's stuff.
Well, you're supposed to be when you schedule something, if you go to the doctor.
Yeah.
That's the thing I don't understand about sometimes you got to wait like, you know, 30, 45 minutes.
Yeah.
And maybe that's different. I don't know. But it's a schedule. And I expect to keep to a schedule.
Yeah, but there are doctors and nurses. They are saving lives.
They're doing very important things.
They are.
Absolutely.
So you can't really give them a lot of heck.
But if you're late, they'll give you a lot of heck. That's for darn sure.
That's true. I try to keep to the schedule. I mean, doctors, maybe that's a little extreme. That's a little different.
Yeah.
But like this guy in his truck, for example.
He's the work mechanic.
Come
on. He's supposed to fix these things.
Yeah.
Exactly. We hopefully started love yesterday. Let's look on the bright side of things here. 60 seconds. That's all you get in hook up or hang up. We put two single people together and we say, there, go talk to each other. So we started with Chelsea. She was our single person. And we ended up with a young man named Brian as well. So here's them yesterday, and it is it's adorkable, and he's 60 feet tall. Listen.
Hey Brian.
Hey.
Okay. How old are you?
I just turned 25.
I was totally pausing. I was totally waiting for him to say, "I am 25 years of age."
Oh God,
that's what always happens. Is people
talk weird.
People do start talking weird. Next, you can hear him say it. I mean, it is very weird when someone says, "How old are you?" To say, "Well, I just turned 25."
Yeah, very all formal,
right? My son says that. Yeah. His birthday was 2 weeks ago because mm-hmm. he's six. You know, anyway.
I just turned 25. You're 22, ooh. Right?
Yeah.
Are you in school?
Dorks.
Yes, I attend Liberty. I'm studying marketing. Will it bother you to know that I still live at home?
What? Come on. No, not an issue. Does it concern you to know that I have my own place?
Has anyone ever been concerned about someone? I have my own place. Is that a problem? Yes, it is. Why don't you live with your mother? Yeah. What's going on here?
He's trying to make it funny, I guess.
Yeah, no. Cute. Nice. Sorry. okay. What do you do? Where do you work?
I actually don't want to give the name of my employer since I'm actually supposed to be working right now.
Okay.
Employer.
Nobody says my employer until they get into this conversation.
Yeah, unless you're in an interview.
Right. Hey, Fred, where do you work?
Well, my employer is Wheeler Broadcasting.
It is somewhat of an interview.
That's true. Very true.
But I work for a construction company.
Okay, cool. So I'm a tall girl. How tall are you?
Yeah, I heard that. I'm 60. Sorry, I'm 6'5".
It's okay.
Yeah, and I prefer. Again, I'm 25. I prefer to date taller women.
Okay, there you go. Yeah. Your time is up. God. Look at that, Chelsea. You heard he's 60 feet tall. The man is a giant.
Yeah.
Maybe he was going to say 6'5". I don't know. He really stumbled over his words, and it was great. But because it was already working out.
Yeah.
Had he just stumbled over, like, how you don't know how tall you are, sir? But they were already all adorkable.
They're adorkable. Yeah. They agreed to go out on a date. I'm feeling good about this one.
Yeah, I feel good about
think
that.
We've got a match.
They're very sweet.
I don't need the 247 different algorithms of match.com. 60 seconds with two dorks.
Hook up or
together.
Hang up on so K92. Sweet.
There it is. So if you want to do a future hook up or hang up, you can hit up Miss Monica. Hit us up on K92 Mornin Thang.com, Facebook, all those things. We will get into the scoopla next. Old school hobbies. Do you have one? You have like an old school hobby? Because a lot of them are going away and we may need to rescue some of them.
Bring it back.
Or not.
Bring it back.
We'll
bring
look
it
at
back.
The list and say, I don't know, maybe it's if we're just, we have more, better things
we
to
might
do
be
now.
Better without it. Yeah.
Some hobbies, it's because we didn't have, you know, stuff. Yeah. So we came up with hobbies like collecting leaves. And now you don't necessarily need to do that anymore because we have cooler things to do. So we'll get into the old school hobbies next.
Well, I believe we are clear on the roads.
Oh, that's right.
My
you
computer's
don't know.
Not working.
Sorry, I'll start
I can tell you
for
about the weather, though, today. Some showers and
we're
storms.
Good on the roads.
Okay, we are clear on the roads. If you see anything, text 52353. Let us know what's going on. Weather-wise, some shower and storms today, maybe this afternoon. Getting to 87 today. 75 at K92. Your next K92 traffic update in less than 30 minutes.
What you could probably start doing at this point, maybe, is one by one disconnect things from that box and reconnect them and see if it affects your computer screen at all.
The little red light box?
Yes, that little black box that's like zip tied to the wall. This is probably what I would call the last ditch effort. Because you know it's on in the back, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. We're doing things here. Yes.
There's essentially like two boxes right there. There's like a slim one, and then there's a big one.
I believe the one labeled the Zach Jackson is old and no longer connected.
Because it doesn't have a power cord.
Correct. Correct. It's the one like right next to it, though, I think.
It's like underneath. There's mm-hmm. like all the way at the bottom. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So.
Hello, Trip. Hello, David. What up, what up? Whoa, dabble didn't on the flow. Hobbies and commercials.
Get your hobby. Get your hobby on.
Lytle. Do we even have a Lytle around here? A little or whatever it's called.
BOGO is back at Little. Through Wednesday, get strawberries $2.29 per bag.
What?
Do we have a Little around here?
A Little? What is
Little's the only, it's a grocery store chain that the Aldi people are also a part of. But it's not, it's different than Aldi. It's Little. Is there a Little like in Lynchburg or something?
I've never even heard of it, so I don't know.
Yeah, there's a Little in Danville. Seems bizarre. I wonder if that's supposed to be an Aldi.
Goodness, watch your knees.
7:27. We have a sleep number at 7:50. Cause I'm little.
Bless you.
Of course, you can let him know that that thing was making its noise of whatever the hell was going on over there. This will be one. Good luck getting an answer. I've got, like, nowhere to...
Hey, Tony.
Blue.
Good morning, sir. My computer isn't working. I'm not sure why. There's one in the back. What's that room called?
The rack room.
The rack room. Yeah, it's on back there.
Tell him the relay thing was making noise.
I couldn't hear you. Say it again. Yeah, that's the one. Yeah, it's on in the back, in the rack room. But it's not on in the studio. Like, the monitor is blinking, but the hard drive somewhere is not on. But Zach said, like, a quarter to six, the relay box?
The relay box
under the counter was beeping.
Stand by. Tracy Morgan tickets at 6:45 and Factor Bullcrap, plus what science says is the best way to cure your hiccups.
Okay, gotta know that. Gotta find that out.
One of the details in there, Monica's nephew had hiccups for a day and a half.
Yes.
I bet you he didn't try this.
No. I don't know what it is.
I guarantee you he didn't try this.
Yeah, well, I can't wait to hear it.
They claim, though, part of me makes, I wonder if they come out with a story like this just to see if people are dumb enough to try this.
Oh,
and then it's sort of a gotcha, woohoo! So that is at 6:45. Then we do the mind reader at 7. It is a 5-number window. That's it. Open your K92 radio app, and you will see the 5 potential numbers that stand between you and $1,000 if you're caller 19 at 7 o'clock. If you don't have the app, download it now. It's free in your app store. You get the podcast on there, live video feed. And the you can listen live to K92 as well, all there in the app. That is on the way. First, old school hobbies, they're going away.
Aww,
are we sad about that or are we not? We'll figure it out. Maybe there's some that we need to rescue. I don't know. Yep. Whoop-a-da. Say it had it was the light was green when it was beeping, but now then it stopped being green. The other light. Baby, why don't you just meet me in the middle? I'm losing my mind, some too little. I, like, touched it and jiggled it a little bit, but other than that, I don't think so. I was trying to figure out what was making the noise. Lovely. Okie dokie, people okie. Karaoke. Okie dokie. Karaoke. Bada-boki. Hey, hey. Oh, man. Where'd the... $1,000, mind reader, 7 o'clock.
Let's go, blah.
Monica, do you have any hobbies?
You're talking about like reading or laying back and, you know, maybe sewing.
Whatever. Talking about hobbies, sure.
Yeah, I wouldn't really count the gym as a hobby. That's something that's not a hobby.
Nope.
No.
You don't really enjoy it that much. You go because
I do enjoy it.
Yeah, but if you could get all in shape and buff without going to the gym, you wouldn't go, would you?
Well, would anyone go?
No, of course not. That's why it's not a hobby. Exactly. That's what I'm saying.
Right now, I guess like my plants and stuff, like taking care of the plants and stuff outside.
Gardening
my landscaping
is a hobby.
And all that business.
Sure.
I'm getting more into that.
Okay.
That's more of a hobby.
That would count. That one, I guess, is still fine because it is not on this list of 10 old school hobbies that are dying out.
Aw.
Trains and model train sets.
Yeah. I mean, but your son,
kids
like
trains,
it. Right?
Yeah, he goes on in and out. He likes them for about 2 weeks, and then
he's done.
They're all over the place, and we tell him we're going to give away all the trains because we're sick of looking at them,
that's
and then
sad.
He plays with them again. And but there really aren't adults anymore that have these fancy model train sets in their basement and things like that.
That's a very old
That used
hobby.
To be a thing. You know, they'd build the little villages with the little Thomas
very
the Tank
detailed.
Engine-looking men and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, very detailed. Quilting.
Oh, well, that should stay.
Why do you scoff at quilting?
I think that should actually stay. Quilting is something that relaxes the mind. Once you know what you're doing, I don't know what I'm doing yet, But I've heard that people enjoy it.
Okay. You've never experienced quilting.
No.
Quilting did get a little hipster renaissance for a while, yeah. So that one may be okay. There's scrapbooking.
They can go.
Scrapbooking is a tough one because there's so many apps. I mean, Pinterest is a scrapbook. So you can save everything there. It's so much easier than dealing with these big giant books and all of the crafts that go along with them.
Don't you feel like you start that and then you never finish it? Like people start scrapbooking. And then it's two pages in and like, okay, well, I'm done scrapbooking now.
One that was big in the 80s when I was a kid is, I remember all like my parents and all their friends going to play racquetball.
Yeah.
We're going to go play racquetball.
Racquetball. Woo! Yep.
Racquetball and the worst named sport of all time. It's cousin squash.
Oh, yeah.
Fred, have you ever played squash?
Never played squash.
Have you ever eaten squash?
Yes. I like squash. It tastes good.
Okay.
I don't know how to play the game, though.
Yeah, racquetball is ridiculous.
It hit the ball off the wall, mm-hmm. right? Inside that glass box.
It's whatever. Basically where two people stand in a box and try to, you know, hit each other in the eyeball with a blue ball.
I see people wear, like, the goggles. Liberty University has a racquetball.
I see our boss Kevin playing racquetball.
He did for a little while. That's actually the last time I played racquetball was with our boss, Kevin.
Oh, that's why I see it.
If I wanted to play racquetball, this was probably, oh my God, probably 10 years ago at this point.
He used to be really into it.
And we went to the Y and we played racquetball.
Look at y'all.
I'd like to point out that I don't think I had played racquetball since that, and I keep saying it that way because I don't know how else you say it, but racquetball.
Yeah.
Probably since I was 12, I kicked his tail.
Really? You won.
I was pretty good at racquetball.
Did you guys wear protective eyewear?
You have to.
Oh, okay. Yeah,
and little shorts.
You get hit in the eye.
Little white shorts.
You don't have to do the little shorts.
I didn't wear the little shorts. Okay. I wore normal person shorts.
Okay.
yeah, and I schooled them.
You weren't really that into it then. I probably
would have played again, but our boss, Kevin, goes in and out with physical activity, so he and racquetball broke up shortly after that.
He's like, I'm done.
Yeah, he was done. Here's another one on this list is fixing up an old car because the new cars, there's nothing to fix anymore.
True. It's all digital.
Right.
And it's stuff you can't fix necessarily at home sometimes.
And it's not as fun. I'm not a car guy, but I'm sure there's some enjoyment level in taking an old car and it's, you know, unscrewing things
and fixing it.
Now, trying to fix a new car is about the same as trying to fix a router in your house. Thoroughly unpleasant.
Well, no one's fixing a new car, but I think that one is still going to stay. It's going to stay. Because I have a lot of friends that mm-hmm. work and rebuild cars.
Yeah, but the cars are going away. That's the problem.
But they can still, if you go and you search, you can find an old junky car and rebuild it. You know,
still do that. That's mm-hmm. true.
You can still build up an old car. Yeah. I'm just saying they're going away. Unless we start the K92 Mornin Thang Squash League, we're just going to have to get on that.
Yeah, that might be fun.
Who's ready for the big summer squash party?
I don't know how to play squash, but the racquetball is one sounds
thing.
Fun.
I think it's a slightly different racket or something, but they're basically the same.
Whatever,
game.
Let's do them all. Mm-hmm. Let's do both of them.
Squash and racquetball.
Yeah.
Exactly. The hybrid.
Our own league.
Factor Bullcrap is next. The scientifically proven, not guaranteed to work. I'm telling you, I think they're just messing with you. They say this is the best way to cure your hiccups, but I think they just want to see if someone will actually do it. Hmm. It is tickets to see Tracy Morgan on the line, so we'll get into that next. $1,000 in the mind reader after that. Only 5 numbers are left. Do you know which number is the one that will win you a grand? We'll find out at 7 o'clock.
Did you get any progress over there?
He said, that's weird. I don't know why.
Okay. Yeah. Cool. Sounds good. Yeah, and then give up. Oh, they're done. Tapped out.
Yeah, I think a little
mini vacay. But yeah, I'm going to have to. God, I don't even know how to do it. I mean, I'm so lost and I don't even know where to start with, like, how to set up this multi-feed thing. But no one will help me. I cannot find someone that will help me other than give me terrible advice like, well, just check YouTube. Like, what the hell do you think I'm trying to do here? What do you search for, though? And trust me, I'm looking. I need. Well, it's just Tony will help when they're done with the wide orbit stuff. Which I get it. You know, that stuff does all need to go in and there's a lot into it. But you can't just, you know, in this world say, I will do nothing else until I get that done. It's as if I said during ratings, well, no, I can't do anything else because I have to do pop quiz and secret sound clues, you know? Yeah. Like, well, I don't have time. You know, no, I have to do that in addition to all the other stuff that I have to do. And if we were truly so overwhelmingly busy with all of these things, then someone would be here at 8 o'clock in the morning doing something with it, but we're not. We're here at noon at our normal times,
checking in, how, you know, whenever. It's no one's modifying their days for these things. I'm just, yeah, at this point, Gerard, it's like, I mean, we can try to help each other, too. I just don't know. I don't even know. I'm not finding a good starting point as to where to really be informed as to what I'm actually researching here.
Hey,
yeah?
Quick question. That box underneath, can you plug it back in really quick?
Sure.
Hey.
The one with the light.
Yep. Uh-huh. Yeah. One more go.
Okay.
Is it green?
Just the red power button is on, no green on the other side.
What about underneath it? Just the red power button.
The only light I see is the red power button. There's a silver button on that thing. I don't know what it does. I don't know if that's something. I don't know what you do when you push it. I can't see any labels on it. Oh, you're not here. I'm talking to nobody. Ladies and gentlemen, it's time for Angry Zach's Factor Bullcrap. I'm your host, King Zach. Factor Bullcrap is a grudge match of two listener friends and random tidbits. Today, the winner gets actually do your choice. So if you want to go see comedian Tracy Morgan at the Berglund Center in October, you can do that. Or I actually still have a pair of tickets left for comedian Joe Coy, who will be at the Berglund Center on September 27th. So it's whichever guy you think is funnier, you can pick. We'll start with caller 9. We will pick two contestants. Y'all will go head-to-head next. So 774-9236, 800-468-9236. People of Earth, this is Fact or Bullcrap.
K92, hello. Hey, what's your name? You said Deshauna? Hey, Deshauna, just be sure to have your radio turned off, okay? All right, just make sure that we're not on speakerphone or Bluetooth and be really loud.
Gerard, I can't tell you that yet, even or odd. I might after 7 o'clock, though.
K92, hello. Hey, what's your name? Hey, Lisa.
There's a silver button down there. I don't know if that does anything.
All right, and make sure that we're not on speakerphone or Bluetooth. Okay. We need to make sure that you're off of Bluetooth, okay? All right, or speakerphone, whichever you have one. And just be really loud and clear, okay? Make sure your radio's off, all right, Lisa? Yeah. All right, yeah, because you sound kind of distant. So just make sure that we're not on Bluetooth. Okay, hold on a sec. Lisa was like, well, do I sound bad? Make sure that you're not on it. Please.
Don't ask questions, Lisa. Do what I tell you. You don't know any better.
She sounds very nice. Very nice.
La, la, la. Very boring.
Oh, you haven't had it.
Nope. Sitting there last night, just.
Why are you doing that? Is there a reason?
I had like 50 million drinks last weekend, and we're going out of town tomorrow night, so we're like, maybe we should probably try to behave ourselves for once.
Oh.
I don't need to be blowing through as much alcohol in the house as we have been lately. It's sort of like, man, I gotta go to the liquor store all the damn time. I'm thinking, all right, I'm gonna scale it back here just a little bit.
Not sure if it really.
Like, sip of wine. Wine, I feel like it's.
I don't drink wine.
Oh, yeah. Because wine, I feel like, you know, you take a.
All right. Cool. But yeah, Jessica went out with a friend of hers last night. They went, like, bike riding and, oh, yeah, and so whatever. And she's like, everything good at home? I'm like, yeah, I'm just sitting here bored. Oh, kids are watching TV. I was like, I already did. I did all the songs for the Awesome Foursome for tomorrow. I did the Eliminator. It's like I did half my to-do list for today. I'm like, I'm sitting here, fine. Do something. And bye. $1,000 at 7 o'clock. Only five numbers. Check your K92 radio app right now.
Arena.
Factor Bullcrap is true, false, with a screw in you. Let's meet our contestants. We say good morning to Deshauna. Good morning, Deshauna.
Good morning.
See, what'd you have for dinner last night, Deshauna?
Steak and potatoes.
Ah, very nice. How do you take your steak?
Medium well.
I knew it. I knew before I even asked. I'm getting a medium well vibe here. That's fine for you.
You
enjoy.
Do you.
Exactly. You do you. I'm trying to be nicer to people who take their steak medium well and well done because there are a lot of y'all who listen to this show, mm-hmm. and I can't scare you all away. So.
Well, thank you.
Exactly. No problem.
Said it's okay.
I'm not rooting for you. No, I'm kidding. Okay. You are taking on Lisa. Hi, Lisa.
Hello.
All right. Dare I ask? What should I ask?
Yes, go ahead.
Lisa, how do you take your steak?
Oh, my gosh. Medium rare.
Okay. Oh. There we go. Wait, no. I'm supposed to be equally excited for both people. So, all right, Lisa, that's fine. Whatever. Deshauna, would you like to go first or second in the game?
I'll go first.
All right, first for you. Perfect, Lisa. You'll go second. Here's the deal. Factor Bullcrap is three rounds. I'll give you a statement, and you tell me if it is. I almost said tell me if it is medium rare. Fact or bullcrap. Now I'm hungry. Anyway, get it right, get a point. Get it wrong, lose a point. You're also allowed one screw. You force your opponent to answer your question instead. Let's do this.
Round one.
All right, Deshauna, here's your question in round one. Fact or bullcrap, Deshauna, there are no escalators in the entire state of Wyoming. Fact, bullcrap, or screw, Deshauna?
Fact.
Is? No.
Oh.
That means you're wrong.
There are two.
Two? I mean, they don't have people there to use them.
There are two in two banks in Casper, Wyoming.
Oh.
And that is it.
Two banks.
That's it.
Just I heard Wyoming is beautiful, too.
It is. I've been there.
I've never been there.
Oh, it is beautiful.
Yes.
Kanye had his listening party for his new album there, and they're just saying, like, the mountains and all that kind
I
of stuff.
I went first. I'd just like to prove that. So yeah. There you go. Yeah, and yes, Monica, you jerk, there are people there.
Okay.
Not as many, but there are people there. Uh-huh. Lisa, here's your question in round one. Factor bullcrap, Lisa. The first phone book was published in New Haven, Connecticut, and had four people in it. Fact, bullcrap, or screw, Lisa?
Fact.
Is
That means you're wrong.
It had 50 people in it.
Oh,
which
50,
was
get it right.
Every single person that had a phone. I'm not kidding. Back in 1878. So all 50
the
of
phone
you.
Book. We still stick with the phone book for some reason.
Oh,
I don't
my
know.
God. And right. Probably even back then it was showing up on your front porch. Like, what is this?
Right.
What is this? I don't even have a phone. I don't know what this is.
All right. So Deshauna and Lisa, your time minus one.
Round two.
Comes with a penny saver. Factor bullcrap, Deshauna. According to scientists, the most effective way to get rid of hiccups is to breathe into a paper bag. Fact, bullcrap, or screw, Deshauna.
Fact
is?
That means you're wrong.
According to them, it's to stick your finger in your butt.
Stop it.
I'm telling. Yes, stop that's it. What it said. Don't yell
stop
at me.
It. That is mad. That's a joke.
That's got to be a joke.
I don't know.
That's a joke because who would find that out? Who was the first person to figure that out? He said, all right, I'm going to try something
a
here.
A very bored scientist.
Yeah.
That's
yeah.
who figured it out.
Who was the first?
That's disgusting.
I don't know.
I know.
Well, if you're desperate enough to get rid of your hiccups, I don't know.
No.
I just read it off the paper. I don't know who writes this thing. Factor bullcrap, Lisa. The average person loses 10,000 hairs a day. Fact bullcrap or screw, Lisa?
Fact.
Is?
No. That means you're wrong.
It's a bit of a bullcrap day around here. Nope. It's only 100.
Feels like more, yeah. But it's only 100.
All right, Deshaun and Lisa still tied, minus two.
Round three.
Third and final round. Both of you still have the screw in play if you want to make the other one answer your question instead. Factor bullcrap, Deshauna. Bald eagles are notoriously promiscuous, and almost all the males cheat on their mates. Fact, bullcrap, or screw, Deshauna?
Fact.
Is? No.
That means you're wrong.
They mostly mate for life, actually. There's only a handful that cheat.
Yeah. I mean, can that's they communicate that we're in an exclusive relationship?
Something like that.
They're kind of like the language? Eat to live, not live to eat kind of thing. You know?
Okay.
They just mate for life.
I guess.
Just, you know, whatever we don't that do it for fun.
Lisa, here's the deal. You get a point on this, you win, and you get it wrong. We go to tiebreaker with the lowest possible score in the history of Factor Bullcrap. So here we go. Fact or Bullcrap, Lisa. The 16 largest ships in the world produce as much pollution as all 800 million cars in the world combined. Fact, bullcrap, or screw, Lisa?
Bullcrap.
Is... Nope.
That means you're wrong.
Tiebreaker.
When's the last time you heard that many buzzers?
I believe this is the lowest scoring game in the history of Factor Bullcrap.
Oh my gosh.
So this goes into the Hall of Fame of sadness. There's minus a sadness six wing of the Hall of Fame.
But tiebreaker, they both have a chance.
Hey, exactly.
Somebody's got to win.
Let's see what happens. They're enjoying Deshauna's themselves, at least. Exactly. That's all that matters. Yeah. So this question is for both of you. You buzz in with your name if you think you know the answer. Get it right, you win. Get it wrong, you lose. Here we go. Fact or bullcrap? Women are more likely to complain about the temperature in the office at work.
Deshauna.
Deshauna, fact or bullcrap?
Fact.
Is...
Oh my God,
somebody got one right.
I thought it was a trick question at first. I'm like, where are you going? But yeah.
There it is.
I mean, it's too cold. I think
about it here. A lot of times it's the ladies that are complaining about the cold. It is.
It is.
I know. I did complain yesterday. I'm like, it's hot in here. Anyone else hot?
See, exactly. Don't act all fake outrage over here.
And everybody in the sewing circle in the back complains about it being too cold all the time.
Oh, Zach, you didn't have to call them the sewing circle.
Walking around with their shawls on or whatever.
Zach.
It is. They knit those shawls themselves to stay warm back there
to have a light jacket or a light sweater.
Mm-hmm. Your emergency sweater.
Yes.
My grandma had one.
Yeah, you leave one at
in
work.
The office. Oh, yeah, I have your sweater, by the way, but I'll return that.
A sweater?
That. Yeah.
You like had a hoodie from you.
No, it's a Patriots sweater.
That's a sweatshirt. Right.
Yeah, sweatshirt. But I still need to return it. It reminded me of that.
Okay, thanks. 55% of women are more like, they don't like the temperature at work. 55% of women say they don't like it. Men, it's only 35%. Lisa, hang on. We do have a prize for you, but it's not the grand prize. That is Deshauna's. She finally got a point.
Oh, goodness.
And it'll be her choice. Tracy Morgan is at the Berglund Center in October, or comedian Joe Coy. He's at the Berglund Center in September. TheBerglundCenter.com for each of them. Next, $1,000. It's a five-number window. Open your K92 radio app right now, and you know the exact five numbers, so you are ready to be caller 19 in about 6 minutes here on the thing.
Are we clear on the roads?
Oh, that's
there?
Right. I got to check that.
My computer's broken today.
Hang on.
I think your computer's on vacation.
Every computer's on vacation.
And there's nothing our IT guy can do. That's what
we are clear on the roads.
We're good to go. If you see anything, text 52353. Showers and storms today. Possible downpours at some point later on this evening. Getting to 87 today. 75 at K92. Your next K92 traffic update in less than 30 minutes.
Now, Fred, there's plenty of things he could do.
Well, he said there was nothing he could do at this time.
Right. Because he done wanted nothing else.
He's at home. I woke him up.
I understand that. Yeah, so. I get that. I know. But
hey, look, I'm thankful for everything that he does for us. I'm not like you.
I know.
You're such a stain.
Well, that's why I can be this way. We can balance each other, because I can say all these things that you want to say.
And then you
can say, no. I mean, I got your back, man.
He's a nice guy.
This is good cop, bad cop. I get out all our frustrations, and then you clean up the damage afterward.
Okay.
That's what it is.
Sure.
Hang on,
Deshauna. Prize too.
I'm thinking she's going for Tracy.
Yes.
Hey, so Deshauna, which ticket did you want? Did you want Tracy Morgan or
Monica? Look how racist stereo profiling right there. You're profiling.
She sounds like black girl.
Tracy
Morgan, Joe Cook, see?
Yeah.
Can you write down? Deshauna, have you won with
that? Racial profiler, Monica Brooks.
I'll put it in later.
Yeah, that's just me being a stay, but it's like, I can't do anything. Well, you could come in.
You could. Yeah.
Could.
Oh, yeah.
There are things.
He said,
if I think of anything before I fall back asleep, then I'll let you know.
Yeah, see?
No, not at all.
Come on.
Not at all. You still call for that. Hey, what's your
this little box. He doesn't have any extra ones. He thinks this one's
all right. Your phone number?
So he doesn't have any extra ones. The one he had, he's at the Lynchburg with Josh the other day or something.
And so all right, your date of birth?
Physically nothing he could do.
Again, oh, we don't have a backup. Why? I don't know.
The backup got sent to Lynchburg.
Order one then. If you remove it, then you got to have one.
What'd you say?
Right. You always have one on standby. Okay. I don't know. I was like, all right. Mm-hmm. I can't keep walking back and forth, man. Nooks and crannies.
Got your info, and we will get those tickets mailed out to you when they arrive, okay?
Haven't even got any coffee.
Oh, thank you so much. You have a good one, okay? Bye-bye. First time calling and winning. She said she decided to call to see if the number even worked.
Well, good.
So that's why she was so excited.
Oh, great. I'll add that in later.
Huh?
I'll put that in later. That's what I was saying. Everybody, we just got to get all their stuff, whether they won with us or not.
Oh, I know.
Yeah, I couldn't do anything. Mm-hmm. Oh, well.
Raul Diaz. Hello. My name is Raul. Hello, Angel. Hello, Ruth. Hello, Gerard. See, look, you can stay with that, with the medium rare.
Yes.
You may remain. Rockna Oogala Bagwa. That's what she says right there. Rockna Oogala Bagwa. Armalta Kushavata Ta Malana Honamana.
This one dude downstairs, he shot him, went upstairs. The girl was in the bed with this other guy, and he shot them both.
Okay, because the dad said that she didn't know any of them, didn't know him, that he didn't know them at all. And I was like, that doesn't make sense, because they're all the same age.
Were they in a house?
You know, and I didn't know they were in a house. So why was the car crash?
He tried to drive it off the side of the thing.
Okay.
To hide the, but I know a guy who says he knows.
Well,
I was like,
no, I mean, it's a small area, probably. Cause I know
maybe, Brian, I don't know.
Because of Broncos, but he knows. I mean, I just didn't follow the rest of the story.
What are you talking? Which store? Which one is this? Oh, okay.
So sad and scary.
Yeah, I mean, what do they have any details on that thing yet?
That's what Brett was talking about.
Does it?
I know that says he was friends with the shooter. Never expected anything from him.
I mean, you got to wonder what's going on, because it was billed as homeless 18-year-old. So why was that? What was the deal? Like, why did he not have a house? What was he doing?
I heard they were in a house. Like, the guy I know that says he knows the shooter said he walked in the house. Everybody was asleep. Guy was downstairs on the couch. He shot him. Went upstairs. His girlfriend was in the bed with some other guy, and he shot both of them and then tried to drive the car off the mountain.
Hmm.
That's what the guy I know said. Yeah, and I don't know him
well,
like that.
Right.
So I don't even know if he.
Well, of course.
You know, because at first, because I said her dad was saying that she didn't know him. And I was like, he was on trying to defend her.
Yeah.
And people were like, just stop. Just don't say nothing about it.
Yeah.
Wow. It's like, there has to be something. It wasn't just.
Interesting.
Yeah, I don't really know the guy.
Stand by.
I don't know him like that, so I don't know how much truth there is. He could be one of the people like, oh, I know. You don't know nothing.
7:01, Thursday, almost Friday. Friday Eve up in here.
Yes.
Yeah.
Brand new birthday scam on the way. Pizza problems. There's a problem with pizza?
No.
We must rescue the pizza.
Yeah.
Yeah, Regina works at a pizza place.
Mm-hmm.
So okay. I'm calling with many long specific demands for my pizza.
Okay.
So
that's
all right. You're doing the Monica.
You
that's
I
what
am.
She says is all right. Monica
you want what
has
you want.
To, she has to defend. She wants mushrooms on one slice.
I did say that
yesterday.
That
is what she wants.
I said yesterday that I had ordered a slice. I ordered a pizza and I said I want one slice with mushrooms.
No.
And
no, you
peppers
get out of here with that.
And
can't
they
do
were
that.
So nice. They did do that for me.
This is over the phone too. This wasn't even like at the counter.
No.
You called over the phone to request this.
Let me just shout out to all
and
of the
nice.
Hardworking
Thank
pizza
you.
Places in the listening area. Don't encourage this
don't,
woman with
no.
her Please special don't. Orders. Don't. I try one because I'd never thought of this before, but I feel like somebody does order this where I wanted half pepperoni and then half sausage. And then I would also like half olives, but on the other half. So it covers a quarter of the pepperoni and a quarter of the, you
yeah.
know, see what I'm saying there?
Yeah.
It's like a hat. It's an olive hat on top of the other two.
Yeah, that's
Plus
ridiculous.
Plus other things as well. So we'll get into that. Pizza problems are on the way. Coming up in the trending, the TV show Lost is apparently returning.
No.
As a reality show.
Reality show.
What?
Okay.
Don't they have that? It's called The Amazing Race.
No, it's different. I'll explain it. Yeah, you'd say or
Make
Survivor.
Afraid or
no,
something. Yeah, Survivor.
Yeah, so it's sort of a hybrid of all of them.
Come on.
I'll explain next. (800) 468-9236 Caller 19. If you've been following along on your K92 radio app, you know there are 5 potential numbers that stand between you and a grand. So it's a 1 in 5 shot. If you are caller 19 next, good luck.
Habba hoda, fluba hedja, henesher, a tuma whiffa, flabba diffa.
Caller 2, caller 3, caller 4, caller 5. Color 6, color 7, color 8, color 9, color 10,
where'd MTV
color 11,
videos
color 12,
those are gone now.
Color 13, color 14. What?
We don't have that MTV video channel anymore. It's just gone.
What? We just have.
It's not even on the list. It's just not even there.
Go to 29.
Not MTV. There's one that's like just 30? There's one that was just the video.
Just
it played
like
videos.
Same, like,
it was like channel 1000 on this thing.
Because usually they had MTV and MTV 2. Color 15, color 16, color 17, color 18. You're saving money. You cut that champ. One champ. Mm-hmm. Mm. K92, hold up. What's your name? Nancy. Hey, Nancy, you're calling 19. What is your guess?
Nancy. Terrible goatee on that idiot.
Okay, be sure to have your radio turned off. Make sure that we're not on speaker or Bluetooth, okay, Nancy? All right. Miss Nancy.
Let's say good morning to Nancy. Hi, Nancy.
Hi.
Nancy, what town do you live in?
Roanoke.
Okay. Nancy, are you following along with the incorrect guesses?
Yeah.
Okay. So you got your K92 radio app. You got all that going down, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Nancy?
Yeah.
What is the number inside Fred the Genie's head for $1,000?
I'm going to say 293.
293 is...
Nancy.
Yeah.
That is too high.
Too high, Nancy.
Oh. That was also the guess from 9 o'clock yesterday morning as well.
Guess.
Nancy.
Oh man.
Yep, it must have snuck by you there when you were checking them on the app. Yeah,
when you're
high.
Reading the app, it's a lot of numbers in there because there's been quite a few guesses. Mm-hmm. Maybe you got confused or overlooked it
by
accident.
Right. It's Nancy, okay. 9 o'clock, you get back here. You know, it's a 5-number window. Study that app. Look at those numbers. Get ready at 9 a.m. to win. So they are bringing back Lost as a reality show.
Well, you're excited, right?
No.
Did you like Lost, the original?
At first,
and then it just fell off?
Then it was the last few seasons were just like Walking Dead, where it just spiraled out of control, and no one knew what they were doing anymore, and it was ridiculous.
That finale, though.
And then the finale was garbage.
That was the only episode I watched.
The finale was the only thing they could do to try to salvage anything. But, of course, it was the rumor that everybody thought from episode one. So it was like a complete waste of time.
Wow, the whole series?
The entire thing was a complete waste of time.
So if I wanted to watch it on Netflix from the beginning, you would say don't do
it.
I watched the last episode.
Just to be a supreme spoiler queen. That's all she did. And then she told people about the ending. That's all she did.
Monica! You didn't watch any of the series. You just watched the end. Yeah. So why the heck would they reboot? Oh, they want to make it a reality show, you said?
So a reality show now. And yes, I'd say don't waste your time because it was great in the beginning. And then the last two or three seasons were a waste of time. But you had to go through them just to get to the end.
Yeah.
Watch the first episode and the last episode and then walk away. Anyway, it's called Castaway.
The Monica.
And it's sort of a cross between Lost and Survivor and Naked and Afraid and all these other things. Maybe this is interesting. I don't know. I mean, it's still a reality show, so we're kind of over all those by now. But 12 contestants will be dropped alone on a string of islets in Indonesia.
Okay.
And they will have to survive on washed up luggage, scattered resources, abandoned buildings, that sort of thing, as if they've survived a plane crash.
You're right.
Here's the little twist. None of them know that anyone else is playing. So as far as they're concerned, they are dropped on this island. They don't even know that other people are part of this game. As far as they know, they could be on one of those alone shows, you know, alone.
Yeah.
So then they're going to encounter other people. They don't know how long the game even lasts. According to this, it says the only way off the island is to make it to an unknown end date or quit.
Okay. Whoa. I was going to say, you don't have a job to go back to. Nope. You'd be like, I don't know.
And they're going to drag it out for us.
Here's where it's sort of a connection to the TV show Lost is they're going to mix it with documentary style flashbacks of the contestants' lives before the show, which they used to do a ton of on Lost.
Okay. That sounds kind of cornball.
Weird, though, because all of a sudden you'll just come up on someone and then realize, hey, you're in the game, too. And then there's two of you. And then you might find two or three other people, and you don't know how many more there are. Are there alliances? Are there wars? Are these people going to fight each other?
Right, I was going to say, because do they become a team, or is it every man for themselves?
That, my friends,
a lot of questions.
I believe, is where ABC would say, tune in to find out.
I'll pass.
Number two.
I'll just have Monica watch the last episode. Let me know what's going on. Number two, all Prime subscribers, so if you're an Amazon Prime person, you now have access to a thing called Prime Wardrobe.
Ooh, what's that?
Prime Wardrobe.
Yeah, they tested this in a soft launch, and now they're rolling it out to other people. And it's similar to these online shopping companies. Have you ever tried Stitch Fix or Trunk Club or things like that? So there's an in-house stylist. And they put together personalized outfits based. You take a quiz saying what your style is and your size.
Yeah.
Then they send you 3 to 8 outfits. You try them on. If you like any of them, you keep them. If you don't, you send the other ones back. You don't pay anything to send them back, and you only pay for the ones you keep.
Yeah.
So it's kind of having your own stylist say, here, try this outfit. Yeah. See what you think.
That's cool. I like that.
It's the exact same thing as Trunk Club.
Yeah.
That's exactly what they do.
Well,
I like one. It's called Menlo Club. Check them out.
And what Amazon likes to do instead is say, no, we need to operate every business. No one else can have a successful business. Right. We need to put you out of business. So let's go ahead and do that.
Number one.
Speaking of, it's also what Facebook does because they think, YouTube is a business. Let's try to put that out of business. So Instagram has launched IGTV. Have you seen this yesterday?
I saw something about it. I wasn't really sure.
It's an extension of Instagram. It's also a different app because it always has to be a different app.
Oh, another app?
Yep. Got to have another app.
Got to have the space for it on your iPhone, too. So if you got an older iPhone, you're running out of space.
Instagram is going to increase its video time limit. Right now it's 1 minute. Mm-hmm. I guess now they're bumping it to 10. I've heard it's going up even more than that. And they're trying to turn this into a YouTube, basically.
Yeah. Like long-form videos.
Long-form videos. They want it specifically designed for the vertical way on your phone.
the crappier way. Let's just put it that way.
Yeah, no, the way nobody really
so
wants.
So Facebook and Instagram are really trying to shut everything down. Mm-hmm.
And Amazon.
That's what they did. Because remember, Snapchat could do these things Instagram couldn't do. And then Instagram, Zuckerberg, and everybody incorporated all the things Snapchat. Yeah. And they did it better.
Instagram had 800 million users 9 months ago. They're up to 1 billion already. Jeez. So it is. There is a decent possibility. I think eventually Facebook goes away. And they focus entirely on Instagram.
I think they hybrid
the two of them together.
I can totally
see that happening. Mm-hmm. Brand new birthday scam is next. Pizza problems here on your thing. Study the numbers in the mind reader so you can win at 9 o'clock. All right, I haven't looked into the chat yet, but something tells me Gerard is very frustrated by that guess.
Oh, yeah.
Nancy! I know, and I knew it, and I asked her.
Huh? She said she was following along.
I know, so you got on the app? Oh, yeah. Okay.
No way.
All right. Must have missed that one.
Maybe that's what I say. There's probably a lot of numbers on there.
Now she didn't say she was following along closely. That's a different story. It is called Castaway, Samantha. Like the movie, I guess. Hi, Wendy. Hello, hello. How goes it? Bruda, Becca Bruda.
Hey, hey.
Fine, Wendy, you're going to be that way, I'm leaving.
Do the show yourself, Wendy! We are happy. It's a happy face.
Are you in town Friday tomorrow? You got
to wait or something. I'm in town.
This kid. Well, kid probably told you about his comedy show at Corby.
Who's there? I feel weird now. Like,
yeah. It's like, it's difficult to, like, with this thing. Well, shoot, I asked for, like, a little keyboard so I could actually do stuff with this.
Yeah, like a little Bluetooth.
Yeah.
Thing.
Whitney, the number that was said was 293, which had already been guessed. So that doesn't really do you any good, but it was too high. So there is that.
Journey to India in January.
You're going on the India trip?
Nah, that's okay.
Who's going to India?
Utara Yoga, they offer the trips every yearly trip, and they go out of the country. And there was one time I thought about it, and I said, no.
You don't seem like an India person to me. That's a long flight, also.
Yeah.
They're a lover of planes. a 90-minute flight to Chicago is asking a lot for you, so.
Go to India. Shit. Just knock me out.
Not Indiana. India.
Like, damn, wrong flight.
This guy on this infomercial looks like someone I would totally expect to see, like, at morning show boot camp as a morning radio host somewhere.
Yeah, he does look like. I guarantee he would say, I was in radio.
Oh, yeah. And he's on a show that's called, like, you know, Scratching the Man. Timmy and Scratch. Rock mornings. Power air fryer ovens. It is Thursday. The weekend is in sight. So let's go ahead and celebrate that. Blow your trumpet. Wow. Brag about what you've accomplished this week. Text it now to 52353. Then we'll talk to you. Prizes for our favorite. We have a bunch of monster truck tickets to give away.
Yeah.
That's for the Motor Mile Speedway's Monster Truck Show on June 30th, courtesy of Shively Electric. Other stuff as well. So text 52353 now. Birthday scam today comes from Bailey. Bailey says, would you be able to do a birthday scam on my mom? She works at a pizza place, and she handles most of the people who call to make pickup orders, stuff like that. She's the sweetest and most patient person I should know. She put up with me for 17 years. She's always telling me about how specific and weird people are about their orders, like Monica, who once ordered a Pac-Man pizza, which would be all cheese and then one little mouth triangle of mushroom, which is...
Monica.
No, absolutely not. Seems like a perfect setup for you. Thank you. That's from Bailey. So here is your K92 Mornin Thang birthday scam, pizza problems.
Thank you for calling Pizza. This is Regina.
Hi, Regina. I'd like to make an order for a pickup, please.
Sure, what would you like?
Okay, first I would like a large medium pizza with pepperoni, mushroom, sausage, garlic, black olives, and actually can I get half pepperoni but not on the same side as the sausage? And actually hold the olives, add tomatoes, and do pepperoni on all of it.
Okay, wait, I'm sorry, can you hang on a second? First, did you say you wanted a large or a medium?
Yes.
All right, okay, but which one, large or medium?
Large.
Okay. And
so then for the second pizza, I'll do a medium. Actually, make it a large. And
no,
I'll,
I'm sorry. What, I'm what? Sorry, sweetheart. No, hang on. I need to make sure I've got the first one right before we go to the second one. Okay, so forgive me for 2 seconds. You were talking just a little kind of fast.
Oh, okay. All right, my bad. I'm really sorry. Sorry about that.
Oh, no problem. I just want to make sure I get it right. So you said you wanted a large pizza.
No, medium.
Oh, okay. Medium. Are you sure?
Yes.
Okay, and now the toppings again?
I need pepperoni, sausage.
Okay.
And I need the pepperoni on one side and then the sausage on the other.
Oh, okay, yeah.
And then half black olives, but so it's half of them on half of the pepperoni and then the other half on half of the sausage.
Oh, okay, sure. And is that it?
Do you have Alfredo sauce?
Oh, yeah, we do. Would you like that?
Ugh, no. Red sauce, please. So then green peppers, tomato, garlic, and then make it all pepperoni, actually.
So not just half pepperoni, all pepperoni.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, are you getting all this? I feel like you're not getting all this.
Sir, I think I have it. You want a medium pizza with all pepperoni, sausage on one half, and then half olive, but only on the half of the sausage, and then green peppers, tomatoes, and garlic, correct?
No. That's not it at all.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm confused.
Wait, do you have online ordering?
Actually, yes, we do.
Okay, fantastic.
What, you know, do you want to use that instead?
No, I don't have a computer.
Oh.
Okay, you know what? Let me just start over. I want a large pizza with red sauce and cheese.
Okay. And then for toppings?
No, that's it. I'm good.
What about all the toppings you were talking about earlier?
Changed my mind. Yeah, the kids hate them all anyway. Actually, you know what? Do you have salads?
Yes, we do.
Okay, cancel everything. I'm just going to get a salad.
Okay, sir. We're kind of busy right now. Can you just pick what you're going to order and make sure of it so that I can take care of you and then get to the next customer?
Okay. You know what? My bad. I'm sorry. You're right. So pizza it is. So let me go with the large vegetarian meat lover's pizza, but no olives, extra peppers, pineapple, hold the vegetables, and this time half pepperoni.
Oh, please. You are joking at this point, are you?
I am, actually. You're on a birthday scam. Hi, it's Zach from K92.
Oh, it is not.
Yes, it is.
No, oh, my God.
Hi.
Oh, my God.
I like you.
Oh, my gosh, you got me bad. I was thinking, what is wrong with this man? There's some kind of malfunction. Oh, my gosh.
Now, this is from your daughter, Bailey, and she said you do talk about, because people do, they have very specific orders when it comes to their pizza.
Oh, yeah. No, it's funny.
I actually give you props. At that one point, I think you had the order right when I told you it was wrong. You're good.
Oh, that's so funny. Thank you so much.
Oh, you're welcome. And Regina, I know you said you're busy, so I don't want to keep you, but happy birthday. Thank you for being a great sport. And when I'm hungry later, I will call for some pizza.
I'm going to count on it, Zach. Thank you.
She was so nice.
She did get it right, too.
Yeah.
That order.
Yeah.
She was nice about it.
Amazing.
I know. She was. Very nice.
Yeah.
You're good. Roads are good.
Roads are good. Yep. We are clear on the roads. Text 52353. If you see anything, let us know, please. Weather-wise today, showers and storms. Getting to 87 today. And 76 at K92. Your next K92 traffic update in less than 30 minutes.
If you're dealing with an insurance company, don't do it on your own. We got some stupid infomercial out in the corner. They're eating half an ice cream cone with cake in it, huh?
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
Cake cone. That guy's
goatee. I can't take it. I'm going to sue him for damages just because I'm sick of looking at his goatee.
Silver hurt my feelings.
I'm going to call Mark Skolrud and his legal team. If you're dealing with an insurance company, though, seriously, his goal is to make sure you're getting a fair offer because you don't know. And the facts are an injured person with an attorney will get 3.5 times more money than somebody who deals with an insurance company on their own. These are actual Skolrud cases. Insurance company offers $2,500. Mark gets that person $75,000. Motorcycle accident. Guy with a broken foot, $200,000 settlement. Fractured hip case, $550,000. Every case is different, but on average, an injured person with an attorney will get 3.5 times more money. Mark deals with the same adjusters over and over again, so he knows when it's a fair offer. Contact Mark Skolrud and his legal team today, 877-444-4444. The initial review of your claim is free. You have nothing to lose. Just let them look at your case and go from there. 877-444-4444. The Skolrud Law Firm, helping people. It's what they do. Oh, the vegetarian meat lovers. It's such a good pizza. Hello, Hamza.
You know, online ordering is
Hi, Samantha. Thank you.
Because you know how they have like little...
The little shape there, the little design.
You see your little toppings? Uh-huh. And I'm like, well, I want jalapenos on one side. And then I want, peppers, green peppers on this side. And I want this.
Why do you order like a pregnant woman?
What?
You have all these random cravings and you only want half of this and 3/4 of that.
I might want something different.
She likes to be difficult. Is really
Why do you like to do that?
Different flavors.
Different flavors.
And then I might want, in the morning, leftover. I might want jalapenos.
In the morning.
So we have to smell them.
Yeah, because Jared opened a box and was like, what is this? So, one side is just meat.
Oh, okay. Yummy! Never mind then.
But the other side has mushrooms on that side.
Gross.
Online order, yeah. Yeah. At all sports. I'm like, can I have two wings with your bourbon sauce? She said, we can't. We can do that. Very nice.
So difficult for no reason.
Well, it wasn't difficult.
I just want different flavors.
Different flavors. Tell me what's your flavor. I was running around all over the place yesterday.
Oh, I saw you down there on Brambleton.
Yeah, what was
and then that car pulled up right outside.
I know, that was like the biggest.
I was saying hi. Don't you see me talking here? And for a second, I thought to like put it in reverse and just like talk to you from behind, but I was like, nah.
But that was funny. It was like the biggest
damn. Hey, yo! Big old Sprinter van just pulls in between. I saw the car first and I was like, is that Monica? That is Monica. Did you get it? Is that where you were coming from?
Yeah.
Oh. Where are you going, huh? You were going to Hemrick's. What's his name in the store? Hamricks.
Yeah, I went home.
I saw you turn in there. I was like, is she going to Hamricks? Yep. You love that damn store.
Gotta go see what her girlfriends are up to.
Uh-huh.
My golden girl. And I had
some
last minute stuff to do for Ava's for asthma camp stuff.
And gotta get her a portable chair.
Oh. Basically. And then, of course, with asthma, they were like, oh, we can't give you the records because Ava is her annual checkup. I had to book it for like April, so they were like, oh, we can't give you the records for her annual. So now I had to schedule an appointment for like next week for her annual. So before they can give me, you know, all that, I'm like,
that's such a pain in the ass.
And I'm like, shit.
I think doctor's offices love the annual because it's like, yep, you're good, give me $500.
Yeah, so her annual, I'm like,
make you come in. Yeah, we can't give you anything at all ever. We can't even answer your phone call until you book another one.
Just bring the forms that we need that day and we'll do it.
Checkbook.
Yeah.
And lots of money.
Pretty much.
Yep. So, just bring us money and you'll be good.
Yeah. Okay.
Oh, that's right. I'm like, Fred, if you want to start prepping, no, can't be doing that. Okay. Well, I'm going to start doing that then. Let's see.
I had to go to the doctor's office and go to the asthma and allergy building to drop off some paperwork there. Where was I? I was going all over town.
You just always on the go, man.
I was like on every side of Roanoke. Just
I'm tired of
that. And then I got home.
If I made one stop, together. I'm tired.
Oh, well, I had like 12. And then I got home and I was like, I'm going to go to the gym. So I went and worked out, and then I got home and I took my mom to went shopping at Walmart, get her some stuff while she's in here. Yeah. So that was, we got home at about 9:30 last night.
Damn, yeah. So you didn't stop really until.
I was to bed at like 11:30-ish.
God, that's a long day.
But it was like all day going.
Yeah.
And when I crashed so hard, it was just like, I woke up, damn it. Damn. His brisket because he is addicted to Mission Barbecue brisket. So, on the way home. But they close in 20 minutes. I'm like, I got your brisket. Double mac and cheese.
At like 10 o'clock at night?
Yeah.
Y'all are nuts.
What?
He's friggin' crazy.
It was,
right, again, so they'll eat brisket and double mac and cheese probably at 10:30 last night, and that son of a bitch probably doesn't have high cholesterol, and
he
I
doesn't
do.
Have,
yeah.
For what? He doesn't, right?
F him.
You know, it is weird how, you know, some people that just eat the shit, and you're like, what the hell? But, yeah, double mac and cheese.
It's crazy, yo.
does sound good. Man, that sounds so good right now, man. Right.
Now,
breakfast.
Oh, shit, yeah, boy. Thang in the house, mind reader at 9 o'clock. There are only five numbers. There's still five. The 7 o'clock guest was a rerun, unfortunately.
Yeah,
didn't help.
Yeah.
But that's all right.
If, but if you got the app, you know. Mm-hmm. You know what it is, and you're happy. All right, she didn't get it. She wasn't paying attention.
She didn't take your
whatever.
Money, so you can look at it that
exactly.
way.
Exactly.
But we'll see go. At 9 o'clock. Up. Open your K92 radio app now, and you will get all of the potential window. So a 1 in 5 shot when you get in here. Blow Your Trumpet is next. You can start texting to 52353. We got some great ones already. Mm-hmm. Here's someone. I don't know if they are 16 or they're just reflecting back on it, but their text says, I got into college at 16.
Whoa. Dang. Nice.
Wow.
That's smarty pants.
Yeah. No.
Either way, looking back, or killing if that's it. Current, you mm-hmm. crushed it.
Or they're saying, I got into it. College when I was 16, so you're a doctor now? I work at Best Buy. I'm Geek
yeah,
Squad.
But that's still all right.
Yep, nah, I'm sure they're a genius.
Oh, absolutely. Mm-hmm. But
or at
some
the genius
of,
bar.
Some
at,
of us geniuses,
Apple.
Fred, we do go a little kooky. We lose our paths afterwards. So.
Us?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, you put yourself in that?
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah? Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. Self-proclaimed?
No, I'm very...
Who told you that?
My mommy. Your mom. No, I actually score very high on all those like nerd
IQ
geniusy
tests.
Type tests. Yeah. And,
I like
and
the mama
like
answer
that.
Better.
Yeah. And my mommy said I'm special. Yeah. This actually, and you know what? She blew a perfect opportunity for me. This is sort of an advanced fork you for tomorrow as a fork you to my mom, because she used to work for Apple Computer back in the day.
That's true.
Maybe you've heard of them. Mm. And she's worked remotely. And when her boss went on, they do these paid sabbaticals.
Mm-hmm.
Her boss paid 6 weeks. You're required to take 6 weeks off.
Yeah.
Paid.
That's so cool.
And she came in to sit in for her boss for that 6 weeks. She acted the boss. So she lived out in California for 6 weeks. And so she brought me out there. I'm probably 10 years old, 11 years old, something like that. And she brings me to the Apple headquarters. And they just sit me down at a desk. And I was very familiar with computers and stuff as a kid. And not a lot of kids were. And all of the people in the building thought I was some sort of child prodigy who had been hired at 11 years old to work there.
Kid genius
right?
here.
And
exactly.
She said no.
Gather around,
everybody.
Yeah,
and they're like, no, she's just my son.
She's
like,
my
yo!
Son. I didn't know where to put him, so I just stuck him right here.
She messed up your status.
I could be that cool Tim kid. Cook guy. I'd be the one standing up there at those dorky press conferences acting all excited about Siri. But nope.
Nah.
You're here with us.
I'm here with y'all, and I love it.
And now your mom lives here, Roanoke, too. We love her, too.
Man, we're all here.
Yeah.
Yay.
Great.
Does she still have connections over
let's
there?
Let's blow your trumpet now because I'm going to cry if we don't. So let's move on. I will blow my trumpet about something that I'm doing this morning that I'm also not happy about. But I'm doing good. So we'll get into that. That is next. We have some monster truck tickets at the Motor Mile Speedway. If you're interested, you can start texting 52353. Blow your trumpet next.
Here.
I don't necessarily need them right this second, because I have us.
Yeah.
But I have texted those three people and let them know already.
Hey, my name is Kenya.
whatever it takes. Monster.
Whatever it takes. Whatever it will. I'm blowing my trumpet because I'm doing something good, but I'm not proud of it. I'm not proud. I'm not happy.
You should
about
be proud.
It. I'm not happy about it.
Blow on this.
Blow.
Friday Eve. What have you accomplished this week? Start patting yourself on the back a little bit. Mm-hmm. That's what we do here. That's how you blow your trumpet. Yeah. And I will start by saying that for breakfast this morning, let me show you, I have salad for breakfast.
Salad. Okay, what kind of salad?
It's a salad.
It's a salad because, you know, I brought in a salad that was really smelly. Greek salad.
Oh, no.
But it's just a regular salad.
Nope,
but salad for breakfast.
Salad for breakfast, and I'm not happy about it.
Happy. It's healthy.
I know. I don't want it.
What's for lunch? Because you normally have a salad for lunch.
I know. I gotta go to lunch with our friend David Kemble of Kemble Tax Service.
Yeah, shout out to David.
And I didn't eat this thing yesterday, so it's sitting here. And if I don't eat it for breakfast, it's going to go to waste. Yeah. And I don't want to waste it.
Okay.
So I'm very unhappily eating a very healthy breakfast salad this morning.
And then that means you can pour it on that lunch, man.
Well, he's going to be full off that salad that he didn't like, that he doesn't like. But got chicken, you got protein, probably...
It's turkey
turkey.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah.
Got some meats and salad in there.
You be quiet, Monica.
She's such a stain, man.
The turkey's great. It can be great.
What do you have?
Can I blow Jared's trumpet really quick? Because this is almost like rubbing it in.
She sets me up with questions like that.
She does, yeah.
What? I mean,
you know, you're trying to get me fired
Let
right
the people
there.
Hear it. Go ahead.
What?
Blow Jared's trumpet.
Jared, real quick, he was last night, the fact that he enjoyed brisket and macaroni and cheese kind of late last night. And he woke up without heartburn this morning.
Okay.
It's amazing. Okay, that's just a quick blow of trumpet. All right. So I'm going to blow my trumpet that it was.
He's blowing everybody's trumpet.
Right.
Everybody line up.
She's
blowing trumpets today.
Here. Come on. Yeah, but I'm going to blow my trumpet that this week has been kind of like hell week a little bit for me. But I've been managing to make it to the gym every
that's
day.
That's good.
And that helps a lot for stress.
Yeah.
So. Yeah, I needed it.
You needed to work it out and everything. So,
so I'm going to blow my trumpet on that.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to this weekend so Monica can sort of reboot and refresh because she's been kind of terrifying to be around this week, Fred. Have you not? There's an edge.
I haven't noticed.
I caught
noticed.
It a little bit here and there. And I'm like, okay.
She almost bit my earlobe off yesterday, I think. So I looked over and.
All right. It's almost vacation time.
It is. I know.
It's all right.
But she's busy. She every trumpet in town. Hey. If you want to line it up,
yeah. Let's blow trumpets.
Monica Brooks, Trumpetal Services are on the way. You next. We have some monster truck tickets to give away. This is for the Motor Mile Speedway, June 30th, courtesy of Shively Electric. So some of our favorite peeps will do that. If you want to start calling now, we actually have Pulaski Yankees tickets as well. 774-9236 800-468-9236. Blow your trumpet next.
The Sheeler Motor Mile.
Sheeler? Let's see here. We call these people.
So many trumpets. Hey, can I blow Jared's trumpet for a minute?
Did
you do that last night? But I'm bummed.
Set
me up trying to get me fired.
No, I didn't.
That's what I'm saying. See,
protein shake.
Breakfast salad.
K92, hello. Hey, what's your name? Ricky, you want to blow your trumpet? All right, what's going on, Ricky? Oh, he put 2 and 3.
Yeah. K92, hold on, please. K92, hold on, please.
Okay, well, be sure to have your radio turned off, Ricky. Make sure that we're not on speakerphone or Bluetooth. We're going to talk to you here in a minute, okay? Okay. K92, hello, what's your name? Alicia, and what is good? Go ahead. Okay, be sure to have your radio turned off, okay? We're going to talk to you here in just a minute. Hold on a sec. K92, hello, what's your name? Jessica, okay, and what is good? Hey, be sure to have your radio turned off. Make sure that we're not on speakerphone, and we're going to talk to you here in a minute, okay? Okay. Hey, Alicia, just make sure that your radio is off. We want to talk to you here in just like a couple minutes, all right? All right, hold on a sec. K92, hello?
Salady.
All right, what's going on, Tommy?
Tommy would like to get in line for the trumpet blowing, I believe.
Oh. Okay. Well, we'll tell him. Thank you. K92, hello. Hey, what's your name? Hey, Helen, and go ahead and blow your trumpet. Hey, be sure to have your radio turned off, okay? Helen, and we will talk to you in just a couple minutes, okay? Okay, hey, one sec. Make sure that we're not on speaker or Bluetooth. One sec. I don't know why they talk to me. They hang up. Like, oh, where'd you go?
I hate it because it's a waste of 35 seconds,
yeah.
You know?
I get all your info. Then you gone. Gone? Oh, your first day with cattle.
Busta Rhymes performed at Dirk Nowitzki's 40th birthday party.
Busta. Hello. Hey, this is Michael K92. We got your text and wanted to talk to you. Hey, just be sure to have your radio turned off. Make sure that we're not on speakerphone, okay? Okay, and your name one more time? You said William? Okay. Hey, be sure to have your radio turned off. Hold one second, okay? We got 3. They're hanging on. 4.
Okay.
Alicia, she had texted in about the brain surgery.
Okay.
But she hung up.
Okay.
La li lu lu la li lu li. Too liquid.
Too liquid.
Hello, William.
Blow on this.
Blow.
Friday Eve, you've accomplished things this week.
I hope so.
And it's time to celebrate them.
Yeah.
And Monica is blowing trumpets up and down the basketball court. William, good morning, William.
Good morning.
Go ahead, William, blow your trumpet. What do you got?
Yeah, I'd like to blow my trumpet. We had some renters destroy our house after living there for 4 years. And each weekend for the last month, I've been traveling to go fix the house so we can move in, and it's done. And my major reward for that, from work is I'm able to keep my job when I move and work from home.
Nice.
Get that, man.
There
you
go.
Set yourself up for even better stuff to come.
Renters are the worst.
Yeah, they can be.
They really just don't care. It's amazing how little it's sort
there's
of
a few that don't care.
I know, of course, there's exceptions, but
I'm a good one.
It's a great example is nobody treats their own refrigerator like the work refrigerator. You think of it that way. So they come in here and they do whatever.
You know what? Some might. Like some people that treat the work refrigerator like crap, they treat their. You got to see theirs. It's probably crap too.
Possibility. Helen. Yeah. Good morning, Helen.
Good morning to you.
Blow on this. Blow.
Take it away, Helen.
Okay, I am going to do some bragging on my granddaughter this weekend. In 30 minutes, maybe just a little less, she learned to ride her bike without her training wheels.
Oh, hey-o. Very nice.
That's always exciting.
I'm amazed. It took me months to learn to ride a bike when I was younger. But she just took off, no major crashes. I mean, just a couple of mishaps, and it was like 30 minutes. She's good to go, and she's like, she's rode all of her life without her training wheels.
That's awesome.
Aww. Helen, she's love growing that. Up.
Uh-oh. I know.
She is. I'm now so proud of her.
She's going to need a big girl bike right. next.
And then Helen's sitting there, I'm sure, watching her go down the sidewalk going, my baby's riding away from me. Oh, I got to get my son off his training wheels. That's my next project. Ay, ay, ay. Parenting. There's always something to do with these creatures in your house. Jessica, good morning, Jessica.
Good morning.
Blow on this. Blow.
What do you got?
So, all week long, the children have been in summer school program. We made it on the bus on time every day so far.
Oh, good. Look at that.
Look at that.
Going to summer camp.
Summer programs. What are we doing this school year? Are they on time then, too?
No.
I'm going to struggle there. But summertime is easy.
It's different. Well, but the difference, too, is you can drive them into school, drop them off. Summer camp, there's a sense of urgency. I got to get these kids out of here, man. If I don't drop them off, I am in serious trouble. Awesome. Congratulations. Freddie Mac, blow your trumpet.
I'm going to blow my trumpet because finally, after putting it off for a little while, I finished putting together my new grill.
Oh, there you go.
I got the pictures to prove it, too. So I had basically done nothing compared to what I did yesterday. I put the whole thing together practically.
Nice.
It's like you look at some of those grills and it's like all these parts, and you look at the manual, it was a million pieces. But it wasn't like as bad as I thought it would be.
It's Legos for grownups. Mm-hmm. Yeah, really.
It was a lot. It was some tedious parts to it, but it was.
Oh, there's always those. Yes.
Yeah, and I was like, what is this? I had to like zoom in online on the manual online stuff. But I finally got it together and I'm done.
Have you used it yet?
No, that was part of the urgency and why I put it together, because Katie, my wife, told me she wants to use the grill today.
Oh, today.
So yesterday she said, can you put it together, please? I want to use it tomorrow.
All right, but you haven't tested it yet.
Have not tested it.
Okay.
I'm going to say a prayer over it first and throw all the holy oils on top of it.
If you live in Fred's neighborhood and you see a little poof of flame up in the air, everything's fine. It's just Fred's lousy construction. That's
all. It's just
all.
Me flying through the air. My grill
just
has
blasted me. Just be careful.
Stand back.
Yeah. Stand back from it.
Yeah. So.
Well, good luck. Text me once it works so I know you're alive and you'll be here tomorrow. That's all I ask.
Okay.
We are good on the roads. Yay! If you see anything out there, though, pull over. Text it to the number 52353.
Weather-wise today, showers and storms getting to 87. Maybe some thunderstorms in the area tomorrow. 76 at K92. Your next K92 traffic update in less than 30 minutes.
So, Monica, you say you're looking forward to vacation. Are you planning on going anywhere, or are you just going to crawl into your sleep number bed?
My sleep number.
That's it.
Yeah, we're like Romeo and Juliet. I just love my sleep number. And when we separate, it's like, why? Why do I have to leave you? Yeah.
But and, I mean, I do and love work are, kill the work other of the feuding parents, yes.
Yeah. Yeah, but it is that great, yep. Though.
Monica's going to build a fort and just live in her sleep number bed. Because yes. it's a bed that knows her, Fred. It's designed for her and her sleeping style.
You get a number.
Yeah, you get a number, and it speaks to you and what you need. Like, Monica's sleep number is 666. That's
No! No! It's a 40.
40.
Luckily, mine, it doesn't go up that high.
No. Mine is a 70. Sleep IQ technology in the morning. Wake up, you have a score, and it lets you know how well you slept. I got 86 last night. Good. Which is pretty good. Sleep number, right now, lowest prices of the season, where it's the final closeout on a Sleep Number Queen C2 mattress with an adjustable comfort on both sides. It's huge. You know, you get your husband can have one number, yeah. And Monica, you can have the other one. Now, only $599.99. You'll only find Sleep Number at the store. So sleepnumber.com or Wards Road in Lynchburg, the district of the Valley View Mall, and you go in, you let them know the K92 Mornin Thang sent you. Abadoo. Go ahead and pick someone you like there and give them a prize, please. Okay.
That's a lot of work. The BS, what that is. Let's see, what do we have for him? Monster. Hey, thank you so much. You have a good one, okay? Hey, thank you so much. You have a good one, all right? Hello, William? Hey, what is your last name?
Bye, Wendy. You're probably gone by now, but bye.
You just said 194, right? Okay. All right, so we have some monster truck tickets for you. And what is...
June 30th.
Oh, the 30th? Okay. So we can get those tickets mailed out to you if you like, or if you want to pick them up. We will do that. We thank you so much. You have a good one. Bye-bye. There.
Going on. Not
much.
Cool.
How are
feel this out. Give us feedback. Let us know what's going on. What'd you say? Yeah, I was eating a breakfast salad, of course, you know, because everyone eats lettuce for breakfast. Yeah, it's really exciting to eat, too. Come on. Hello. There you go. Yeah, it was just as good as bacon, of course. Way better. No, I had a leftover salad. It's like, fine, I'll just eat this. Whatever. Fine! A lot.
30 something, right?
8 quarts.
Wicked lots.
I don't know how he's. That's just the sauce. I don't know how we started talking about it yesterday, but Katie and I were talking about orange chicken. We were talking about, oh, because she okay, so I've never had cantaloupe with, I love cantaloupe, but I've never had it with salt. And so it'll change your life, but it's salt, right? I'm like, you don't get all heavy with the porn over there. She's like, tell me you've had salt in your watermelon before. I was like, no, I've never had salt in my watermelon either. Yeah. She's like, oh my gosh, I'm gonna change your life.
There are people that pepper on cantaloupe, yeah.
Oh, okay. I've never had either until she introduced me to it like a few weeks ago. Uh-huh. So yesterday she was cutting up some more cantaloupe or whatever. She's like, just need some salt. Yeah. I was like, all right, well, don't get too heavy with the salt because, you know, I'm black and we have like high blood pressure. And she was like, what did she say? Sodium doesn't discriminate or something like that. Or like basically saying it can happen to anybody. She was like, you know. She's like, all that stuff. She's like, you know, you just have a different mindset about it because you see the salt going on it. Versus like something where it's prepared for you, but you don't see them put the salt and stuff on it. And she was like, tons of stuff. You eat Chick-fil-A, Panda Express,
so much
all the sodium, blah, blah, blah. And I'm like, wait, hold on. First of all, Chick-fil-A is God's calories. It doesn't count.
God's calories.
There you
God's
go.
Calories.
And then it reminded me of how me and Alex were talking about the salt content or the sugar and salt and stuff in Panda Express or whatever.
Yeah,
because I didn't know that ahead of time. I was just like, it's good food. I know it's not healthy. It's not like greens, but
like if you prepare it yourself.
Well, yeah,
right.
Because you can put as much salt, sugar, or butter in stuff when you make it yourself, and it's not going to be as much as anything that's like at a restaurant or pre-prepared or whatever.
I just give her a hard time. Sodium don't discriminate.
Meow, 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 meow.
Sounds good.
Bow, wow, wow.
Grab some drops while you're doing it, too.
Bow, wow, wow.
Two birds, one stone.
Wow.
Hey.
Win $1,000 at 9 o'clock, and you will certainly be blowing your trumpet. You'll be very excited about that.
Yay.
Let's see. Text 52353. Other people blowing their trumpets this morning. We have someone 5 more weeks of summer class until they graduate from Virginia Western. Good
That's
job
exciting.
There. Let's see. Wife, mother of 5, board certified behavior analyst traveling from Covington to Lynchburg 3 days a week for training and slaying it in all things. So there you go. Wow.
Worth it.
Kenya says, so much has happened this week. I'm pregnant, and my husband and I got to finally see our future child on the ultrasound.
Oh.
And she's getting promoted to department manager at work, and he's getting promoted, too.
Dang.
That is that week is so much better than yours, Monica.
Ah, yes. That's good.
Monica's been like, this week has been taking forever. I need to you've been slaying it.
I have
Don't
been.
Don't get me wrong.
Just keep on pushing.
I joke about it because it's one of those, like, if you ain't laughing, you start worrying, you start overthinking everything. Here's a great one to just sort of take with you on your day or on days when you have adversity or whatever. This is a text 52353. Today is my birthday. And around this time last year, I was unemployed, lonely, single, and fighting depression. Today, married to the love of my life with a great job.
Look at that.
And they say, believe and have faith in yourself. Don't think of the tough times as that. Think of it as character-building times. Lastly, thank God for all my blessings.
So, that is right. You pray about it, you keep on going.
Exactly.
That's how you do it.
Birthday scam on the way. Pizza problems. She was adorable.
She was nice.
She was very nice because I was very difficult with my pizza order. Which, it was based on a true story of Monica's pizza order. So, that's what it
makes sense.
Inspired by true events, that birthday scam, by the way. True story of a woman and her pizza. Dua Lipa. Oh, Monica, this is very exciting for you. I put soccer on for you.
You have your salad, but I don't want my juice today.
No. It's just the Soulja Boy juice over there. That's what it looks like, the name of it. It's like Soulja Boy. Soulja Boy, don't like it. Oh! Yeah, I've decided at least just watching men kick a ball is better than having the news on. So we'll go with this. At least they're just running around and fighting each other for fun. You guys have RVCCU at 8:20.
Okay.
Said, boy, I don't give a flarn filth. Hi, Nikki. Hello, Kevin. What is going on, yo? Don't give a... I gotta text Timmy. Which was at noon. It got moved up to 11:20.
Okay.
This is one of those things, though, where it's like lunch scheduled. Just nobody really asked, any of us. And then also yesterday, oh, by the way, it's been moved to 11:20. Oh, okay. Well, I'm over here just doing nothing.
Yeah.
Always available 24/7. Just remember that.
No, I guess him and Lillian were talking about it. And I was like, I have none. And he was like, oh, yeah, I don't have any either. Or he said, I have one, or something like that. But anyway, it reminded me of those. Yeah, but they have them for men now. Mm-hmm. But they're like crossbodies in the fanny pack style. Mantle, I don't know, Merce.
It's an F-Mac, isn't it?
It's an F-Mac.
It's an F-Mac. I'm wearing my designer F-Mac today.
I don't know, but I think it crossed my mind the other day. I was like, what if I had one?
We should start
Can I pull that off?
Let's do your brand. Instead, we'll rip off Yeezys, but we're going to call it Fmeezys. So FM for Freddie Mac. Fmeezys.
Fmeezys.
Brand new birthday scam, pizza problems is next.
He's so in love now. John Cena is back with his fiance, Nikki Bella.
Shade.
What? He's in
love. The way you say it in such a sarcastic manner.
Monica used to like John Cena, she has not enjoyed any of this whole relationship breakup makeup thing because she dumped him.
I'm okay with it. They won. They got what they wanted. I'm talking about him.
She won, really.
She won it all because her Total Divas show was garbage. Until she dumped her fiance, and it looked really ugly. He poured his heart out on TV.
This is wrestler John Cena and his wrestler fiance, Nikki Bella, who, just to bring it all together, they broke up right before they were supposed to get married.
She dumped him.
She dumped him, And we thought maybe it was cheating. And then we find out it was things about, like, he had said he never wanted to have kids. He's had a vasectomy, that kind of thing. He didn't want to get married.
Did y'all know he had a vasectomy?
No.
I didn't know that.
If you have a vasectomy, you're dedicated to not having kids anymore. Zach, you know, Monica's husband, like, you're dedicated to not having
kids. Well, you do that. That's a procedure where you mean business.
You mean business. And now he's saying he's going to do the reversal.
Yeah.
Crazy.
Reverse vasectomy, all for Nikki Bella.
I can't imagine.
So she's so excited that she has a twin sister, and they've already been talking about getting pregnant at the same time, so they can be like, oh, that's so cute.
Hey, going to be fun on the show. We're getting played here. Time. We are getting played.
It's all for ratings. It's all not
ratings. Sure
you're
is.
Talking
they got
about,
it.
You're talking about bringing another kid into the world and all that kind of stuff. That is a totally different scale than, oh, we want people to watch our show or watch our wrestling matches.
But people will watch.
That's not good. Yeah. It's not a good way to start off.
They get it from the Kardashians.
They did.
The Kardashians, they know how to get us, how to pull us in.
Yeah. Here we
are. And speaking of the Kardashians, Kim, she does have rules. And she does, her kids, they have chores.
She has a chore chart that she has to make her bed. She has, you know, there's so many things that she has to do if she wants to get something. So she doesn't really get a whole lot of stuff like you would think.
I love how there's so many things. She named one thing. She has to make her bed, and there's so many things. Like, you can't think of any other chores, sweeping.
And of course, the difference is, you know, in your house, if the kids get 10 stickers on the chore chart, they get to go get ice cream. North gets a Bentley. That's that's just the
toy car
slightly difference. Mm-hmm. Pizza problems, birthday scam next. Then we roll into the Google game, and we have Shorty the dog, adoptable love.
Oh, okay.
I'm guessing like 30 pounds. It's this weird sort of mini-ish dog, which is why she has the name Shorty. So we'll get into that. Birthday scam next. Shorty wanna ride with me. Oh, vacation mode. Love you / hate you, Nikki. So wigga. Doodly doo. Oh, baby. Ooh, baby. Did I get my Google game? I did. Okay. Wait. Wait. No, we cannot. La la. Wait. Go with him. He's just another dead guy. What? I need to see what is on sale at Earth Fair. Weekly deals. Checking deals. Deals.
And you woo woo woo.
Monica's singing the jams over there. And you woo woo woo.
All the hit.
M92, Monica Radio. Deedle 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 doo. Let's see. Oh, baby. No, I don't need that.
Don't make me do it. No, I'll go and get you. Hey, everybody. Hey, buddy. Hey, dude. I got a little bit nasally. So she's a little. Hey.
Sometimes those free, like, Friday things at Kroger, I'm like, I don't even want this in my house.
No,
it was that big jug of Ocean Spray juice. Thinking, it's just going to take up room in my fridge and no one's going to drink it. Forget it. Nah. Never mind. Oh, Monica, there you go. Family flip-flops.
Huh?
And get yourself some ground beef and some flip-flops this week. Family flip-flops. Motor oil. I got to get on Jessica, man. She said she was going to wrap up your wedding gift so you can have your wedding gift.
Katie asked me about that yesterday. She's like, didn't Zach say he was going to get us knives?
I have them. They're sitting in my house.
And I said, yeah. He said Jessica wouldn't let him give them to us until they wrapped or whatever. They wanted to wrap them.
She's like, she
said, I don't think you really got us anything. That's what he said he did. I don't think he did. She's just kidding around. I don't think you really got us anything.
I'm just going to give you knives out of my drawer.
Here you go. Some butter knives.
K92 Mornin Thang, Mind Reader, 9 o'clock, Fred the Genie. They're trapped inside your head right now, Fred.
Yeah.
This round actually started very, very quickly, and I thought they were going to guess it in about 4 seconds.
You underestimate me.
You thought that too, though, at the time, didn't you?
Yes, that is true. Uh-huh. Based on the last time. Because
you underestimate
so
you too.
Well, people pay attention and they pay more attention than you think. Mm-hmm. So they're able to whittle it down really quickly. Yeah.
But if you go to the K92 radio app, all the previous guesses are on there. So you know it's a 5-number window. Freddie Mac, what are you doing this weekend? You have plans?
This weekend, I am DJing a wedding.
Okay.
In Lynchburg.
He can't get enough. He got married 2 weeks ago. He's back.
I'm back, baby.
The boy's addicted to weddings. He can't leave.
Uh-huh.
It's sort of been a nonstop for you every weekend because you got married, then you went glamping last weekend.
With the in-laws, and then now I'm back to DJing, and then I'm going to take a week off, go on my honeymoon, and then back to DJing for the rest of the year.
Well, you know what? Things cost money.
They do.
Wives cost money, Zach. You know
things
this.
Cost, your own wedding, it costs money, so
that
you have
too.
To work.
I am well aware wives cost money.
Paying
so,
it off,
there you
so,
go.
Yeah.
I'll tell you this much, though, Fred. You know what costs more money than wives?
Kids.
Ex-wives. So be
ex-wife.
Careful.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Ex-wives.
No.
Oh,
I don't want that.
Mm-hmm.
I don't want the ex-wife thing.
Ex-wives cost
that.
A lot of money, so that's why you got to make money now to keep them happy or to pay them off later, whichever one it is.
Great advice.
Yeah, exactly. I have the worst advice.
Back at it.
It's called money.
Make money, money, make money, money, money.
Then the family wants us to go on the Disney cruise in February.
Oh, her family?
Yeah. I was like, OK.
okay, well, all these weddings I got the rest of the year. It is almost every weekend, give or take a couple, four weekends, maybe the rest of the year, I'm not DJing weddings. I got pretty much every Saturday and occasional Sunday.
Yeah.
These weddings on a Sunday.
That's the challenge of doing that job. It's like I've always thought that. I'm like, oh, yeah, I mean, I could. And it's good, you know, you make some good money. But, man, it's you got to work on the weekend. Yep. And that's
pretty much your Saturday afternoon / evening.
Right.
Like Boo Bash, like Boo Bash weekend, I don't have anything except Boo Bash.
But you still have that. So
I got that, but right. But that's on a different level than, like,
right.
You know, than DJing.
I just know how cranky I get. Like, even if I have a 2-hour appearance, I'm cranky on a Saturday.
Yeah.
So I can only imagine having to work a wedding every Saturday night. But if you like it,
yeah, it's
right,
a completely different thing. So.
That's how I always knew. I'm like, yeah, I would enjoy the money, but I don't think I'd really enjoy the process, which means I can't do it. I'd hate it. I would hate life.
Yeah. Because I wake up every Saturday or, you know, Friday night, I'm getting ready for it, like putting playlists together, whatever. And I'm like, I don't really feel like it. Whatever. And then I get there, get through all the important stuff, and you get to like the dancing, and it's like everybody's having a good time dancing, you know. It's the best night of somebody's life.
Money
and,
always talks to
and then it's just like, okay, at the end of this, money's coming. Yes. Right. Yes. And it's just, I do thoroughly enjoy people having a good time.
You guys
but
do,
also, yes,
you
the
have
money.
RVCCU at the end of this.
Okay. Thing. Yeah, the money
but if,
is,
I mean, because if it
was definitely.
Like, fuck that noise. Y'all can enjoy it on somebody else.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. It is kind of weird, too, when I DJ and I get paid in advance.
Yeah.
Like, the bout, like, everything is paid for in advance through my company. So. When I am DJing like a wedding I've booked on my own and I'm not getting paid at the end of it or whatever, it's just like, I got paid for this. Like, I don't really feel like doing
man.
It. It's like,
I don't even get anything at the end of the night.
Uh-huh.
I already spent that money.
If I do like a wedding for like Kid Carter, like that money's coming like the next week or whatever I see him. So it's like, you can look forward to that money. With this wedding, I already got paid for it. So, but no, it's still like, yeah, now the work has to be done.
Yeah.
But it's all good. As those checks cash. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? I guess you don't know if you would enjoy it enough. In addition to not having your Saturdays to yourself, you don't know if you would enjoy it enough to give up your Saturday.
This job consumes me enough that I need the weekend to not
do
another thing.
Oh, like when I started doing this show last year, it changed a lot. Like the weekends, it's like, you know, you really do need like a break. Because it's just more, which is all good in the end. You know what I mean? To me,
that was part of the reason too. It's like I'm traveling tomorrow. I'll be back on Saturday, and then Sunday I've got some side hustle business to attend to.
Where y'all going, by the way?
And so I was like, you know what? I'm taking Monday off. Screw this.
Yeah.
Because of that. I'm going to Vienna, which is south of D.C.
North
Wolf Trap is the venue.
That's what we were talking about, me and Michelle, a while back.
Yeah. Nice place.
Concert.
Nice area, too. You're going to a concert?
Which, is it Atlanta?
Hmm?
It's Atlanta.
Manchester Orchestra.
Okay. Because we were talking about Atlanta's Morissette.
Date night, or is it like...
It is me, Jessica, and my friend Joe, who also is a big fan of Manchester Orchestra. So,
Joe's
third wheeling
a little.
He's like, yeah, he can get third wheeling.
He's done it before. He came. He went to an Alt-J concert with us once, and you know, we go. He's very foodie, like I am also. Mm-hmm. So we go and eat someplace nice. And
nice. Why'd you ask about tomorrow? What you doing? You got something cooking, don't you?
Huh?
No. What? Traffic. Got the traffic.
Incident-free on the roads. If you see anything out there, you can always pull over. Text it to the number 52353.
Weather-wise, showers and storms today are possible. Getting to 87. Some thunderstorms forecasted for tomorrow as well. More likely tomorrow, definitely. 77 at K92. Your next K92 traffic update in less than 30 minutes.
Monica and Freddie Mac here. We want to talk to you about the Roanoke Valley Community Credit Union.
Yeah.
There's always times where you have an emergency or you think, okay, I need extra money, but I don't know where to turn to. What do I do? Well, call or visit RVCCU because they have your back and they have the new hybrid HELOC loan. That is a loan where you can lock in your balance at a fixed rate and still keep your line of credit.
You can apply for that HELOC loan and get an interest rate as low as 1.89%. You can apply online or just do some more reading up at RVCCU.org. If you're like Monica and I, you need that customer service. I need to see your face. I got to talk to you.
That,
I want to know how serious you are, what you know. You know, tell me what I need to know. Angela's in Salem. Melissa B. at the North County branch. Brittany's over in Cave what Spring. Up? Katie runs the downtown branch, so they have four convenient locations just for you. So if you live, work, worship, or even go to school in the Roanoke Valley, you can be a member. Roanoke Valley Community Credit Union, lending for life.
It's big like balls. Like Shaq's balls.
Bruno Bade.
Friday. I don't know. I just need to do something this weekend. Like,
that means I need to drink. I need me a couple Proseccos. I don't know what you drink.
That's tomorrow, right? Katie's off tomorrow, so she just works Saturday.
Date night at home?
No, I was going to take her out somewhere. I don't know where yet. Kind of tired of Mexican. We've been crushing Rodeo Grande recently. Not crushing it. We just had, like, enchiladas at home. There's something Mexican at home the other day, Rodeo Grande the other day when I had that big margarita. Thinking, like, time was the comedy thing? Eight?
La 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 ta po bi li la ta ta li ta.
Think it's already?
Hmm?
Monica was thinking about going to Big Lick. No, I mean, Star City Comedy.
Yeah. Corey's here, right?
Yeah, he's in the front.
Yeah.
Okay.
Sherry let him in.
Actually, if you want to get, I'm going to have Alex run the controls here.
Oh, we have the little headphones.
Yeah, the little itty bitty JBCs. Yeah. Little Circuit City.
If somebody has like a very.
What'd you say you want to do? Skull. Ball controls? What'd you say? Have Alex come in and run the switcher.
Oh, Alex.
Like, who's Alice?
Alice?
Go ask Alice. Yes, maybe you know
He lost worse the second time than he did the first time, even though both times he got a zero.
I only have room to go up from here, you know?
That is true.
Hey,
oh, you're
Shorty.
At, you're deep in the valley now.
She needs some confidence.
Yeah. You are cute.
Girl, can't get any worse.
All right.
Corey, good thing about the group game.
Stand so I can just size you up here.
Oh, yeah. Big head, little headphones.
That's right. We do it just for comedy. That's the only reason we do this.
Thank you, sir.
Shorty. Corey, Alex, Alex, Corey. I can't remember if you guys have met or not. So.
Meeting last week, Alex?
Yeah.
Okay, so yeah. So just never have more than three on the screen. But you can have one or two or whatever and just feel free to bounce around with them however you want. If you click on one, it puts it into the preview. You click on
thank you. Thank you.
You're
there's
Fred,
There's a 100%.
Thank you. Otherwise, you have the freedom to do however you want to do it. Hey, Shorty.
This is a great example of a dog I would adopt if I had a if I didn't have a dog that didn't like other dogs.
Ah.
They're getting a great dog with Shorty. Nice.
Shorty. Shorty want to follow and into the hole, holy boy, oh, put your pants on.
No, she got a nub. They have her as a lab mix, but I imagine it's like at least four or five things she's mixed with.
Yeah.
This coloring, this body type, this weight. It's just that nub.
She's a mutt. She's a mutt.
Yep. Which is actually healthier. It's healthier.
And then she's got the brindle, which says pit bully something in there too. Could terrier. Be, yeah.
I've seen hounds with brindle. I just really love the brindle coloring. I think it's absolutely beautiful. You might want to be a lap doggy. You want to be a lap doggy? Come on, you want to?
There we go. Shorty, put to the cycle.
It's a shame. She needs confidence. But
yeah, I know, Brandon. I liked the chew, but Tally ruined that show. He ruined it. I mean, he destroyed that brand.
I haven't seen her. She's just timid and... Sorry, I had to readjust.
No.
I get my weave for free.
Yes.
My man buys my weave.
Pat your weave, ladies.
Pat.
That's right. Freddie Mac couldn't pay for his own weave.
No, heck no.
That's like a girl buying her own drinks.
That's what I'm saying.
Absolutely.
I get the guys to buy for me.
Heck yeah. Mind reader, 9 o'clock. Get your Remy weave money.
Hey.
Hey, that's good.
You know. The good stuff.
Really good stuff.
Remy's the good stuff, right?
Yeah.
100% human.
I don't know. I got to refer to Monica because I don't know anything about it.
As opposed to Monica's, which are 82% human.
Oh, whatever. I go 100%. You got to.
18%.
Oh, okay. Ooh, it was a question mark.
I don't know. Yeah. Actually, Monica goes to the ones that say 100% human. That's what it is.
Oh, no.
Let's say good morning to Corey from the Roanoke
SPCA. Hello. Thank you for having me.
What up, Corey?
What's going on? Ready to play the Google game? Shorty the dog is in here as well. An adorable 2-year-old female lab retriever.
A mix
terrier,
of everything. Mix.
Just run down the list.
Yeah, she's a mix of all,
yes. But so adorable.
She is. Just she needs confidence, sweet. But she's absolutely beautiful. Yeah. Mm-hmm. She's a great size for apartment living, small house. She's really timid. She just wants to walk right next to your legs. There's just so many great qualities to her.
So we are going to try to meet Shorty next. So she kept running away from me a second ago. As we get ready to play the Google game now.
Google.
Good morning, Google gamers.
Morning.
So everybody got World Cup fever?
Yeah.
No, Corey, you're a World Cup guy.
Not so much. I've been seeing some of the drama, though.
We did put all of 1 minute on here earlier because we were so sick of the news. We put soccer on, but not really.
No. But Monica, it's everything you love. A sport with no scoring whatsoever. Just like watching the Dallas Cowboys offense. Oh snap! You'll see what I did there. Bazinga! But seriously, when the game ends in a 0-0 tie, aren't the guys thinking, I ran like 10 miles for the last 2 hours for this? They could have just played foosball in a nearby bar to settle things. Let's start game. Hooligans.
774-9236 or toll free 800-468-9236. You're going to team up with somebody in here. You got Monica. You got Freddie Mac. You got Corey from the Roanoke SPCA.
I'm going to be picked last.
Well,
for sure.
You've delivered 2-0 so far in your life in this game.
I like the underdog role, you know?
Yep. And hey, you'll win eventually. even when Stephanie was with us, even Stephanie won. And I think it took her, I don't know, 6 months to actually win the Google game.
It's okay. You see what he did there? He cracked the joke and everything.
Expectations are way lower now. This is great,
Your choice on prizes. Family four-pack of tickets to a Pulaski Yankees game plus food vouchers. If you're in the Roanoke, Salem area, you can do Salem Red Sox. It's Grease Lightning Night tonight. And tomorrow night is Flashback Friday as they celebrate the 80s. Or Monster Truck tickets to attend Motor Mile Speedway's Monster Truck Show June 30th, courtesy of Shively Electric. All of those, 774-9236. 800-468-9236. Google Game is next. Mind Reader, 9 o'clock for your $1,000. We now go to the dog cam. So if you're on Facebook, we'll show you Shorty the dog, who's up for adoption right now.
Hello there, little timid. Edward, we should have your radio turned off and just make sure that we're not on speaker or Bluetooth. We'll be on shortly, okay? All right.
Show everybody your soulful eyes and stuff.
Show them your soul.
Show them your soul. Right now, I just got your butt. I mean, come on.
Sounds weird. You can't see anything. You just...
She's very shy, but that's okay. Not everybody needs a crotch sniffing dog, you know? Those dogs that don't respect boundaries. Hey, here you are. What are you doing? Stephanie used to always pick up the dogs that were way inappropriate to pick up. I mean,
she
like
picked up Millard and like shook him and then he threw up at
him. Yep. She did shake the vomit right out of a dog. That did happen. But yeah, 60, 70 pound dog. Just picking them up, tossing them in the air. It's great.
It's a reasonable response. A reasonable response.
Yeah.
You'll keep you.
Tell my friend happy birthday. I almost used the dog emoji by accident.
Talk about dogs. Happy birthday, you Bowser. Hey, how's it going?
Oh, shoot. Look who it is.
Cool. How was the dentist?
The dentist?
Ah, okay. So this wasn't a you have 27 calories type thing. Yeah, come on in.
Which do you go to? It's not bad. I have to come back and get plates, different plates every 3 months.
It's a process.
Sounds like a cheap. Yeah.
Oh, it's just a consultation. Word. Oh, feel free to grab a chair if you don't want to stay.
Wow. Mind Reader is on the way at 9 o'clock. You could win $1,000.
Yeah.
Now we play the Google game. It'll be Monica, it'll be Freddie Mac, and it'll be Corey from the Roanoke SPCA, and Shorty, who's sitting in his lap right now.
So precious.
Oh, she's chilling right now. Let's say good morning to Jessica. Hi, Jessica.
Hi.
Jessica, who would you like to team up with today, Monica, Fred, or Corey?
I'm going to take Freddie Mac.
Okay.
Doctor. Hi,
Jessica. There we go. I mean, again, Corey has delivered two consecutive zeros.
Guaranteed Monica's
game.
Next pick.
Micah, would you like to pick Monica or Corey?
Come on, Monica.
Ah, okay. Shocker. Wow.
Micah has a way of getting screwed over by Monica in games,
oh,
though.
Micah, that's right.
So this could be Corey's day.
Oh.
I don't know. I'm just getting a vibe here. So, Corey, Edward, it'll be you and Corey, okay?
That's great.
We're going to shock the world, Ed. We're going to shock the world.
He feels good about it. It is three rounds. You are trying to predict real live Google searches. This is, you know, when you type it in and they start filling in the blanks for you. Everybody has 100 Mornin Thang bonus points with which to wager. The number one answer gets you double your wager. Everything else is single your wager. Three rounds. Round one is now. Let's predict the popular searches on...
How do you play?
How do you play? What are people asking? How do you play?
you play?
How do you play?
If you're watching us on Facebook, you can see that Corey has a dog in his lap. That dog can be yours.
It should be yours.
It should be. If you want a sweet dog, this is not one of the situations where we come in and say, this dog requires a 19-mile run every day.
No, not at all.
No, it is not that at all. She's super sweet.
There's lots of love.
Gray.
Yeah, requires some love.
Yeah.
Grayish brown dog, brindly color as well. She's definitely
soulful
a mix
eyes.
Of many He's, different.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but if you did a DNA test, it'd be a plethora of different breeds.
Oh, yeah.
But she's got a great mix, whatever she has.
Yeah, you send it off to one of those dog DNA places. Yeah. They just write back all. They just check all the boxes afterward. Round one.
How do you play?
Everybody lock in with your guesses
Locked.
And your wagers.
Locked.
Monica, what'd you put and what'd you wager?
20 points on chess.
Chess, 20 points. That's good. Yeah.
That's
chess.
A good game.
Freddie Mac.
I was between instruments and you know, kids games. I'm going soccer.
Okay.
15 points.
15 points on soccer. Corey.
I'm going with the American version of soccer, aka football.
Football.
Football internationally as well, but 20 points.
20 points on that one. Okay. Some good guesses. Let's see what we got here. How do you play? Number one answer. You can also weigh in at 52353 if you're playing along.
How do you play?
Oh, that's not the right one, I guess. Sorry. 1 second.
How do you play? Uno.
Uno.
Oh, come on.
I know Uno's pretty easy.
It is.
But I guess if you don't know what you're talking about.
I'm going to know champ, though, too. So I already know how to play it.
I haven't played Uno in so long.
Oh, we got
to
get a game.
Reverse back
man.
To me. Reverse back to me.
Skip you.
There's got to there has got to be a drinking version of Uno, right?
Oh, definitely.
Oh, we're in on that.
Yeah.
Yep. Thang Drunk Uno. We'll broadcast it live on Facebook.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. This is happening. Uh-huh.
How do you play Fortnite?
Fortnite. Yeah, that's a big one right now.
How do you play Go Fish?
That one, I mean, really.
Come on.
You got to search for that.
Is there a drinking game associated with Go Fish?
I think you can play a drinking
play
game.
There's a simple game for Go Fish. Throw all the cards away and just drink.
Then we can play Twister. We can play Twister and drink. And do
yeah, you can do all of them.
Oh, that's dangerous.
Guys,
that dangerous.
Life is a drinking game, okay? Let's be honest here. Last one.
How do you play poker.
No points for anybody. Good guesses, but no points. So you're all fairly even. Fred, you have 85. Corey and Monica, you have 80.
Oh, I'm in the race.
Yeah, round two of the Google game is...
How do you grow?
How do you grow?
How do you grow?
What are people trying to figure out how to grow? You can watch this all go down on the Mornin Thang Facebook page. You can see Corey and Shorty the dog sitting in his lap. Roanoke SPCA is open noon to 6 every day. We have a picture of Shorty in a post with information about her on our Facebook page. If you could share that would be great.
Yes,
that's really the only way to really spread the word because otherwise Facebook won't. So if you can share it, that'd be fantastic. Do you have more summer camps this summer?
We do. This week's a little older group. Last week we had a younger group, but all of them are full except for the July 2nd through the 6th week, which is an older age range, the rising 7th through 10th graders. But it's a great experience if you're trying to.
Oh my God, my daughter loved
career.
It. Yeah. She went last week. The Roanoke SPCA does. It's basically like a veterinarian camp or pre-veterinarian, and you guys take them all over the
all
valley.
Across the valley. Yeah, they got to go to Kentland Farms, which is the Virginia Tech dairy farm. That was pretty interesting. We've gone to a variety of different places. We went to Fort Chiswell Animal Safari Park, which was really cool, interacting with bison and camel and whatnot.
My daughter loved it so much. On the last day, I thought she was going to cry when it was the last day of camp. And I said, Corey will put you to work at any point if you want to volunteer
this
summer.
Down.
She's coming.
She's great.
She was very excited about that. So back to the game.
How do you grow?
Locked.
Fred.
How do you grow weed?
Yeah, that's a good
20 points.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
I'm sorry. Was I so excited
weed?
About that?
They
just made it legal in Canada. That's all I know.
So how do you grow weed? I believe if it is on there, Fred, it's going to be, how do you grow weed? Asking for a friend. Corey.
I have 20 points on marijuana.
Marijuana, same thing. Yep. 20 points.
I was thinking that, but I'm going with a beard. 25.
25 points.
That's just natural. Yeah. Right, Freddie Mac?
Some people get patchy.
You can't teach that, right?
I got a couple uncles that are jealous of my beard. They can't grow one. Yeah.
Yeah, I can grow a beard, but it's not as thick as Fred's is.
Yeah.
Fred is, his is almost, it's like Steve Harvey's mustache, just extended into a beard. So how do you grow? Number one answer.
How do you grow broccoli?
Broccoli.
What kind of lame answer is that?
Who cares?
No one cares.
Maybe that's code for weed. Who knows?
How do you grow potatoes?
Oh, no.
How do you grow garlic?
Who cares?
How do you grow Tomatoes.
I'm surprised.
What kind of lame.
I know, y'all. Those, that was a good answer. I'm
we
not
got
sure.
Some gardeners out there doing hard Google searches. You know?
Again, I'm starting
potatoes?
To think. Isn't broccoli? Might be. Anyway. We're still very even here, though. Fred, 65. Corey, 60. Monica, 55.
Okay. Oh,
so,
we're in it.
Finally, final round. What is this?
Prince.
Prince
what? Prince what?
Prince.
What are people searching for that starts with Prince?
Prince.
Blow Your Mind is next. Fred, I say it all the time. This would be the worst day of Fred's life if this
Every
was
time.
Him. And then I find another snake story. So
oh, my gosh.
I have one of those coming up and lots of drunk people doing stupid things. Because, again, life is a drinking game.
Seriously.
These people are losing. Except in Monopoly, you go to jail. It's just fake jail. These things, you'll go to real jail.
Prince!
That game takes way too long.
Everybody know? Oh, Monopoly.
2 weeks.
No. Drinking Uno.
Yeah.
Monopoly's a
Camelot.
Waste. Monopoly was invented during a time we didn't have television, okay? There was a reason.
Oh, yeah.
Not anymore.
Makes
Corey,
sense.
You ready?
Yes.
Okay, what'd you put? What'd you wager?
Prince Harry, 10.
Okay, 10 points on Prince Harry. Monica?
I was thinking Prince Charming, but I'm going Harry All.
Harry All, okay.
Hot so biscuits.
That
one can't
big.
Win, right?
Wait,
no.
100.
She gets it wrong.
Okay, yeah, well, yeah, exactly. Uh-huh. We'll see. Freddie Mac.
I was thinking Prince of Egypt.
Okay.
Oh, I think I'm in the race here, guys.
However,
I'm a contender.
I'm going Prince Harry.
Yeah.
60 points.
60
points.
So
if we all get it wrong, I win, correct?
That is correct.
Yes, let's go.
If Prince Harry is not there, Corey will win. If Prince Harry is there, Fred will win. The
He's
number
so
one answer
it's
is.
Good to feel, it's good to be in the race, man.
Yeah.
Prince!
Oops, sorry, I hit a button. Where's my other keyboard?
Dang it.
All out of the way here. I know, I was trying to pause it for dramatic effect, and I ruined it, so let's just get into it.
Okay. Prince! Harry!
Oh, my God. Sorry. Game is over. Freddie Mac wins.
It was great enjoying your excitement there, Corey.
You were excited for a half a second.
I mean, I finally put up a good performance. I'm proud of myself.
You did okay.
You ended with points.
You didn't get zero, so that's a start.
Yeah,
here's
the
rest of them for everybody playing along. Freddie Mac is the winner, so we'll get to Jessica in here in a second. But.
Prince William.
Prince William. Yeah.
Prince Charles.
Yes.
Prince Philip.
Yep, all the royal
princes.
So had
I gone all in, I would have lost regardless, right? I just want to make sure that there's no way I could have won, you know?
That is correct.
I don't beat myself up on the way back.
That is correct. You can know that you lost no matter what.
Yeah, okay,
you're good
that's
to
a
go.
Good feeling. That's a good feeling.
Shorty is available for adoption now at the Roanoke SPCA. They're open noon to 6 every single day. She's super sweet, only about 35 pounds.
Please.
This is a perfect size
dog.
You're
getting a great dog. Yeah.
In my opinion, and I believe... Loyal forever and ever.
Oh,
once,
I imagine.
Once
she wants
decides,
to, she's going to love you forever.
Oh, yeah, no doubt. So feel free to share that post as well on her Facebook page. Next week, Fred, I say it all the time.
Oh, no.
Worst day of Fred's life if this was Fred. And then we find another snake story, and I say, worst day of Fred's life if this was Fred.
This.
So we'll get into that next.
That was a rush, guys. That was a rush. I thought
he said that was a rush. That was a rush. Felt that rush. Blood was pumping.
Oh, I was very much in it.
Yeah.
Well, what I banked, because I wasn't too confident, so I banked on you guys going too far in had we all lost. But, you know, that was my only shot, I think.
Basically. Yeah.
So I did play to my cards.
You did. You did. In that case, you did.
Having not known other people's guesses, but trying to figure it out, that would be correct. Yeah.
Or Monster. Any of the three.
Okay. Yep. Okay. Hello, Jessica. Hey, so you have your choice. Did you want the Sailor Red Sox tickets, Monster Truck, or Yankees?
Awesome. Thanks, right. Corey.
Yep.
Bye. Take it easy.
I'll see y'all. Let me get your last name.
I've never had like real authentic Vietnamese food, and it made me so sick.
Well, Viet Sub is that's authentic, right?
Yeah.
You ever had Viet Sub? Mm-hmm. It's off of William. It's not William.
Okay, so I guess what did you eat that you what do you think you ate that made you ill?
Fish.
Yeah.
And it was really spicy, but I like spicy.
Mm-hmm.
And then I went home and I was like, oh my god, I don't feel okay, and then it just
did
Did anybody else get sick?
My mom got really sick too.
Next weekend. Did it sit out? It was a cookout, so was the.
All right, thank you so much. Like, you have a good one.
It was hot. It was like off the grill.
Mm-hmm.
I would
wager what happened then. If it wasn't, because usually what happens at a cookout if you get sick, it's either because the food sat out for a while and then someone eats, you know, macaroni salad that had mayonnaise in it that got too warm, or they could have had the fish sitting out before they cooked it for a long time or something. Yeah, that's not good.
Other than, but it was good.
That'll ruin you on a cuisine. I don't eat Chinese food because I got violently ill two different times. So I just, you know, I don't
fish?
Eat it. I don't like.
What kind of fish do you
eat? I don't know. It wasn't nothing I've ever heard of.
Okay.
Zach's like, Zach's apparently a loud vomiter.
Oh my God, I'm so loud.
He's like, Rah!
Yeah, it's like I'm giving, one of my roommates in college said, you sound like you're giving birth to an alien.
That's just hilarious to me. I don't know why.
Yeah.
You know, throwing up is like one of the scariest things in the world.
I hate it. Because
I feel like my body's just going to turn inside out.
Yeah.
Yep. If I have to throw
that's
up.
That's why I miss the toilet because
I go. I mean, it's. I got sick a couple years ago, knock on wood, but I have to go to the basement bathroom. So I'm not like freaking out the children.
This was,
you know?
When Suzanne Northrup was here?
It was so bad.
Was that stomach sick that? Okay.
Yes.
Because I was like.
No, wait.
Was that stomach sick or was that like. You had like flu.
I went out day drinking.
Because you lost weight.
No, I just, I had, I got like the flu.
Been to Big Lick?
Yeah, that's what
I think is what it was.
Okay.
I was going to Ballast.
Because you were out for like
okay,
I was out for a week.
Yeah.
And I had a fever like every day.
No,
that one was not a throw up one.
We went to,
but I had, I think I had the flu because I've had the flu like two different times.
Yeah.
And when you have the real flu, the one time I got it, I got it so bad. I had a fever of 102 for a week. All day. It never broke. For five straight days, I had a fever. I mean, I just thought I was, you can't even, I just laid on the couch. I couldn't even watch television because I couldn't focus on anything. Remember, I just had the game show network on because it was, I could just have it on in the background, you know, that kind of thing. But I couldn't do anything. I couldn't move off the couch.
Yeah.
Finally, I managed to drag my ass on like day. Huh? No, this was the flu. Yeah.
The worst time he had the flu.
After about 4 or 5 days, I managed to drag my ass. This is before I had kids, fortunately, too. I dragged my Xbox like from downstairs up to the TV by the couch and just laid there. And I played old Tecmo Bowl because I had one of those mods, you know, where you could play the retro games and stuff.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And I just laid there and played because Tecmo Bowl was not super involved. So I could do that and barely feel anything. Okay. Yeah. And I just
imagine
there.
Him just dragging, like he says, dragging it up from the basement, like dragging it by the cord. Just like
I pretty much was. I mean, that was pretty, I mean, I was kind of like dragging my ass downstairs. Yeah. Like you're walking on the ground, like that sort of thing.
Oh, God.
Yeah, Micah, it is you. It's definitely you. It's the worst. But I lost 10 pounds both times I did it. I lost 10 pounds.
Never had it. Never had chicken pox, never had the flu, I never had any of that.
They shouldn't.
My brother broke out. He had chicken pox and he broke out in hives once.
Woo. School, I got whooping cough.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, that's scary too.
And I was like, how? I'm grown. How kids get this?
I'm a big kid now. No.
Like when I get ear infections, they're like, you have an ear.
And it was so bad because they like they sent out like the notice to all the schools in Roanoke County and it was on WSLS and I was that one person that had it.
Yeah.
Dang. Oh my God, they don't expose me.
Your face just
the one.
Watch out for this kid. If you see this kid walking around, she is highly contagious.
Here we go. Mind Reader is 10 minutes away. There's only 5 numbers separating you from your $1,000. Let's get that winner at 9.
I want to
end it right here. I don't want to give it to anybody else
KT
on this radio station.
You know
we
she
need
does.
The winner.
She broke my drawer yesterday.
Zach is so upset
she did.
About
she
his
broke
drawer.
Because now the keyboards
well,
have to sit on top
drawer.
Of the... Whoa. Whoa.
That's what we determined. We're, Fred broke the drawer,
I
right?
thought we were blaming it on KT. Zach
yeah, we
just
are.
Said KT.
We pardoned Fred, okay? All we right. just we pardoned however
I'm a part
we
of this
want.
Show. She's not, so we got to blame it on somebody. I'm
There's
just saying.
Only 5 numbers left, and the winning number might be an odd number. I don't know. It might be. I just...
Look, Hmm? What? Dang.
Hello? What happened?
Huh? I tell you what.
I tell you what.
I mean, it might be an even number. It's not. but it might be an odd number.
Okay.
Allegedly. I have no idea. Okay, several different drunk stories here. So instead of the boom, 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 I'll give you a little
wow
every time we get to it. Here's the first drunk idiot who got arrested, flipped his car, got a DUI. His name, Benjamin Beer.
Wow.
That's...
well, they set him up for that. Like, yep.
Benjamin Beer, a month before his 21st birthday, driving drunk, flipped his car. Gosh. He did survive, but yes, Benjamin Beer. That is the end of that one. The next one. See, these are the things, they don't set you up for success. Here's another one. She got busted for DUI while wearing a shirt that said, alcohol you later.
Wow.
Wow.
Wow. Yeah, that's no good. Stupid.
Catherine Lulua in Minnesota, driving drunk, crashed into a ditch. Oh, by the way, her third DUI.
Wow.
Is not, that person should not own that shirt.
No.
I'm sorry. No.
Should be allowed to drive.
No, they shouldn't.
Last drunk one. Drunk woman proposes to her designated driver. He says no, so she steals the car.
Wow. Dang.
What? How that is really drunk.
Okay, it ladies, and you can admit this. There, a lot of ladies, they get unreasonable and irrationally emotional when they get alcohol, too much of it.
Well, there's some men that do that too.
Oh,
Monica,
no.
Monica was around some guy she didn't even know. He just came up to her friend group and started crying.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, he did.
Some guy was crying.
Did.
Like, so guys do it sometimes,
they
too.
Do. But where it changes over with women, and I've experienced this in my life with old girlfriends back in the day, is they drink too much. They don't know their limits. They get all sick.
Yeah.
And then they want to cuddle with you. And it's just...
Let's go.
You have to stop.
You want to cuddle?
Right. This is the same thing. So she's like, I love you. We need to get married. No, no, no. We're good. Here's your house. And then just steals a car when he's not paying attention.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
That's so irrational behavior.
You know what we say to that?
Wow.
Oh, no. Now let's get to the worst story of Fred's life.
Oh, no. I'm scared.
Today version.
Blow.
Revised.
This guy, he's a forest ranger, so he's in charge of doing these things of how you deal with animals or whatever. So he does the thing where he's posing with the big python mm-hmm. snake.
Not a good idea.
Yeah, it almost squeezed him to death.
Dang.
Yep.
Wow.
Wow.
How did it? I don't know.
Well, you know, you pose for pictures, or you put the snake on your shoulders,
yeah.
And the snake said, cool, this neck looks good. Let me
go
ahead.
You got a good neck, sir.
Yeah. Start squeezing his neck. He can't breathe. Yeah. People have to rush to his aid to try to help him, and because he was posing for his victory photograph. And the snake got agitated during the pictures.
Taking too long.
And
they get the right angle already.
Yeah.
I get frustrated, too.
He's okay now, but that's got to be terrifying, too, as snakes just start to...
You come with like an inch with of death or whatever?
Yeah, I mean, Fred, just imagine a snake on your body.
That's why I'll never
laying there with...
A great picture if you were dressed like Britney Spears with that snake?
Yes. We'll do that for Halloween,
Like Britney!
No, we already decided on Halloween costumes. Nothing to do with snakes.
Except for yours.
Or Britney.
Man Brit.
Oh, my.
As it sits there.
Oh, no.
In your ear.
Those things, like, I will never understand those people that put the boa constrictors, pythons around their neck and pose with the... I don't care where you are, how highly trained the person is, supervise... No.
Fred
Fred
won't even do a pool noodle because it's too close.
No.
Yep, can't do it.
No, everything on the ground, and it looks like... I saw a stick on the ground. It looked like a snake, and I jumped.
Shoot, can't even eat
almost
spaghetti.
Pushed Katie into the woods, into the bush.
Can't even eat spaghetti.
Some of those fatter spaghettis. He can't even eat those.
I don't like the big ones. Too scary, woman. Tiny ones only.
Angel hair. That's it.
Oh, nope. Fred.
This fettuccine's too fat and snake-like.
Do you get upset when it rains and all the little earthworms come out? All the little mini snakes?
Yeah, because there's always a lot of them, too. That's a no for me, dog.
We are incident-free on the roads. If you see anything out there, you can text it to the number 52353. Yeah. Weather from Randy Jackson. What do you have?
I think we got showers and storms today. So, yay, earthworms. 77 at K92. That's your K92 traffic now. Got a P?
Yeah. This is Monica's note to me. P.
P. Bah. Bah.
If we had to do RVCCU, she has to pee. I can't wait for that.
Oh, it'll happen. You'll be here doing it yourself. That's all it is.
I know.
Wow.
9:23. Gerard. Gerard, what are you doing? Oh, baby, baby.
How long were you sick for? Friday through Monday. All weekend.
Oh, that sucks. Yeah. Yeah, it's Chinese takeout type cuisine specifically. I can make like Chinese type foods at my house. I'm okay with, but I don't do like I would never go to Panda Express or anything like that. And other people can. It's just I'm so scarred by it. Yes, that to me doesn't count as Chinese food. It's sort of like an Asian fusion-y type thing, and it's more of a sit down-y restaurant. So again, for me, it comes down to Chinese takeout. And specifically, I don't know exactly what it was that got me sick the last time, but I'm pretty sure it was either a lo mein noodle or there was one that had like some seafood in it. It was one of those two, but I stay away from all of the noodle dishes 100%. So I've been a couple times where people have gotten Chinese takeout and I've eaten like, you know, beef with broccoli or lemon chicken, you know, something like that. Those are all right. General So's, I'm okay with that, but there's something I won't do the noodles and I won't do any seafood. Just yeah, welcome back.
Yeah, I go from like having to pee to I'm gonna pee my pants.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That place over there in Towers, next to that sandwich place you were disappointed with.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Well. The Chinese place next to Red Wing Boots.
Yeah.
The name of it.
Great Wall.
Is that Great Wall? Right.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, they're very good.
Because they used to be on the other side and then they moved.
Oh, they moved. All right, cool.
Yeah.
Because I thought there were two different ones. I didn't realize.
No, they were by the old subway and then they moved to the other side.
What was that one on the other side of the Kroger?
Uh-huh. It's Hibachi.
Hibachi is the
Japanese. No, on the Kroger's that.
Right. There used to be one that was like right to the left of the Kroger.
Yeah.
That's the same one. They just moved to the other side.
You said Subway, so I was thinking across.
Well, the Subway used to be right to the left of the Kroger also. It was like wedged in right next to where the Urgent Care is.
Okay.
That used to be a Subway. And then they moved that across the street.
There's like a Hibachi on the other side.
Yeah.
Yeah. I don't think I'll ever go there.
Oh, I go to Hibachi.
Is it good? I've heard good things. I've read good things.
Well, now they moved.
And then
well, here's the reality. That happens to every like fast foodie type restaurant everywhere, and that's why you always see like how they remodel. They just tear it down and start over. That's what they do about every 5 years now, just to keep it as clean as possible. Because it's easy. It's honestly, it's easier to do that for them than to try to clean it.
True.
And they just tear it all down and they start over. Whitney owns a corn snake. See, now Whitney, I just own corn. That's all. I'm good. Got a couple cans in the house.
These animals will turn on you in a second.
The corn snakes freak me out. They're the ones that we had in here. Oh, the ones I didn't like because they got those freaky eyes and stuff,
those
and I don't like
that.
What's
the ones that like all the colors? What's the orange, black, yellow?
Maybe.
I don't know. It was just like,
I don't like any snakes, man. JJ had the back door open today when I went back there to get ice. I'm like, I think a snake's going to crawl in. I'd be too scared, y'all. I'm trying to go back there. I'm just minding my business trying to get ice, and I start hearing. I'm like, yeah. Any of those things, like skunk, snake. Shoot. If the rabbit is big enough, it'll scare me.
We do have a rabbit.
I don't like any of that stuff, y'all. Like, I just don't leave me alone. We had a story the other day. Like, some lady opened her screen door, and between her screen door and her regular door, or she opened her regular door, so between the doors was a snake and a
lizard.
Snake and a lizard fighting. And then the snake, she closed it in the door, so half the snake is in the door, but the lizard somewhere like ran into the house. So the lizard was
room.
Some bruh. Like I would go crazy.
And it was like I thought it was a toy, so it was like I had a box fan that was sitting there. And I was like, Dwayne left his toy in my room. Why was he in my room? And I go to touch it, it goes, this little lizard room.
Oh, God.
I'm like, and then it just jets off.
Makes your heart stop.
Oh, no. I was my mom would come in with, she always had this big ass knife. She would just chop like
whatever. Yeah. So every time I open the door now, I open it pretty slowly. Pretty slowly at first, and I kind of look out. Ever since you told me that story, I look out slowly, real quick, and then I go. Every day.
She's telling me, I don't even know why, but she's cut the tail off and pour salt. It'll dry it up.
Like a snail? Salt?
Like, no, like lizards and stuff. Cut them.
Look at this video.
Get some salt. Get you some Mortons. Yeah. Some Mortons salt.
Yeah.
It's a spot in New York City. You literally can just lay in beds and snakes.
No. Okay. It's like snake massages you can get now and all that kind of stuff. No, that is not relaxing at all. Unless you're a psychopath.
I don't like slimy stuff.
All right, yeah. I'm having a hard time. I have a love-hate relationship with gummy worms.
But I think it's cool to swim with sharks.
Say it again?
Swim with sharks? Yeah.
Mm. I know some people have done that. Just recently, too. I forget what she was.
I'll just do that in Cancun.
Oh, females?
Yeah, I think so.
Not during that time.
Oh, my God, Monica. You're disgusting.
What? Like, it's a shark. It's
you're so.
What is that? What are you drinking?
It's disgusting juice.
Know.
It's disgusting.
It's.
Did you get an Earth Fare?
No. What was that Walmart? It was really healthy and delicious at the time.
Everything is green.
Mm-hmm. All green.
Ooh. It tastes gross though.
It's a little gross. Maybe if it's
you
really cold.
You should. It's gonna be gross. Any of those drinks are. All of them are gross.
Sometimes I enjoy it, but if it's really cold, it's probably.
The Synergy one's good.
Yeah. I think the sugar, like
it's
this
really
is
gingery though.
It's like only 7 grams.
I can just
drink
and eat just the most random stuff.
It smells a lot.
God, that smells
everything.
Like just
everything green.
It smells mostly like cucumber though.
Mm-hmm.
The cucumber and
you
celery.
You taste everything else too, yeah. Mmm. Mm.
Cucumber and celery, my least favorite.
Just take it. Oh, I have this lotion that you got.
You don't like cucumbers?
Not really.
This cream that you must try.
Like, not really, like, I don't really like most salads.
Zach tried it.
Too. I do. I like cucumber. What? Oh, that's.
I
don't.
Cream. Don't
try
hate
her
it.
Cream.
I won't pick it off like I will like mushrooms.
See, he doesn't hate it.
What? Cucumber.
No, we're talking about cucumbers.
I know.
There's such a difference between like a cucumber from the store and a cucumber from the farmer's market. Yeah. They're so much better at the store. Ha! Kidding. There's only 5 numbers separating you and $1,000. The number inside Freddie Mac's head might be an odd number. It might. I don't know. I mean, it could be an even number.
All we know is we want to get the winner on this show right now.
Yeah.
We don't want to wait anymore.
I can already hear KT when she comes in. Y'all are cheaters.
Yeah, she's going to say that.
Cheaters. That's
a, oh, where? You put a where to
that,
it?
Cheaters.
That voice. It is kind of her voice a little bit.
I know. She's going to be in here in a second, too, because we're going to play Name That Tune on the Facebook Live feed and the podcast thing. I got some good songs we've kind of forgotten about.
Okay.
Yeah, in Name That Tune. So that'll be fun. We'll do Birthday Scam on the radio, but let's see right now.
Come on.
If we're a bunch of cheaters.
You are so bad.
Womp, womp.
Let's get it.
Oh, my gosh.
Seven seven 4 9 2 3 6 800-468-9236. Caller 19. You know there's 5 numbers in there. It might be an odd number. I'm a cheater. Give me the number right now, and you can win $1,000 in the mind reader. Caller 19. Good luck. Not fair. You can do that.
You're gonna make me spit out my coffee.
My cheaters.
Color 1, color 2, color 3, color 4, color 5.
Bob, on the other hand, is like, I don't care.
Color 6.
Over it.
Oh, Bob.
Yeah.
Bob will be like, well, whatever King Zach wants, that's fine.
Like, that random girl tweeted, sent me that message. I was like,
she that was so bizarre.
Me. It was weird. She doesn't follow me either. So I'm like, why did you send it to me asking why somebody said happy birthday? Thank you, though, but somebody from the K92 Twitter sent me happy birthday.
Like, is it okay? Can't someone just say, like, how dare you?
Color 14, color 15, color 16,
Bob.
Color 17,
mostly Bob.
Color 18.
Have you met Bob?
Hello?
Bob Patrick. Probably haven't
seen
him a bunch.
Yeah,
I think
hey,
I introduced
Rebecca,
you,
so you call 19,
a while back,
guest?
But yeah, you don't, because he's usually here at like 11, but he stays on that side
okay.
of the, and he does the afternoon
all right,
show.
Make sure that we're not on speakerphone or Bluetooth. Hold on a sec.
So yeah, he, so yeah, this girl.
He's actually really good at the Twitter. You know, he pays, he's on
keeps
top
up
of
with
it.
And stuff.
He likes it. So
he loves doing that. Refuses to get a Facebook ever, though. He's never going to get Facebook.
Well, he is.
Oh, I hate Facebook. I do it for work.
It's gradually becoming something I hate.
Facebook?
Yeah. Like, I mean, it's just kind of like,
I'm just mostly on Snap and Insta. I do a lot of Snapchat.
I don't like Snapchat. I would, if I'm ranking them, Instagram, Twitter. That's really the only ones I enjoy.
There's a tie for last
Facebook
place.
Is for work. Snapchat is last place. I'm just, yeah. I'm out of it. I'm done by then. I mean, I'm managing 5 Facebook pages. I'm out. And a website. And Instagram and Twitter, forget it. That's it. I got to make a cut somewhere, and I'm cutting there.
I just hate how Insta has stories now, like Snapchat.
Well, because they're going to put them out of business.
They're trying to, yeah.
Yeah, don't.
Well, Zuckerberg wanted to buy Snapchat a couple of years ago or so, and they didn't want to buy it, so they refused. And so he was like, all right, screw you. And then, like, a month or two later, you can start doing stories on Instagram, and then you could start doing all the stuff on Snapchat on Instagram. Still can't swipe up yet, though. Unless you're verified.
Monica Brooks.
Is
it all together?
Mm-hmm. Waji doji daji in the middle.
Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Hello, Rebecca.
Hello.
Rebecca, can I give you $1,000?
I would love for you to give me $1,000.
I would love to do that, too, because otherwise this carries over to noon and somebody else is going to get the winner around here. Yikes. Okay, Rebecca, you know the window, right?
Yes.
Okay, cool.
My heart is pounding.
All right. Well, let's not put it off any longer. What is the number, Rebecca?
289.
Rebecca?
Yes?
You're too high.
Oh!
No.
Give her like 3 more guesses or something.
Rebecca, I'm
Rebecca.
Sorry.
Yes.
Oh, man.
That hurts a little.
Oh, it hurts man. A lot.
Yep.
A lot of it.
Yep.
Okay.
You got to come back at noon, Rebecca, because
I will.
KT is probably going to get the winner. Yay for her.
But hopefully it's you, Rebecca.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm rooting for you, Rebecca.
We are.
Thank you.
Oh, man, I want to just let her have another guess.
I know,
seriously.
But we can't.
Are there mulligans? What if I hit the dump button a bunch of times? Can we go back in time? Is there time travel on this thing?
Not yet.
Where's the time machine when you need it?
We're working on it.
Boo.
That's tough.
All right, I'm going to enter it into the app. If you've really been paying attention, you know it's 289, so it's between two numbers. And if you are paying attention, you know which one it is.
Someone will have it today.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
They'll get it.
It will happen today.
We won't.
So, friends,
won't.
It's been nice with the mind reader as we now bid farewell to it. With some funeral music in here or something.
It'll
play
be a noon of
mind reader. I don't know.
Ah.
Womp womp.
Womp womp is correct.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Let me get my trending. I'm not prepared because I'm sad.
Sad.
So, AMC, the channel. The one that's got Walking Dead on it and stuff has rolled out a subscription plan to take on that movie pass.
Oh.
Okay. At the movie theater. Mm-hmm.
At the movie theater. So this is $19.95 a month. They call it AMC Stubbs A-List. Now, movie pass right now, I think, is $10 a month.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
And movie pass, you can see a movie. Are we back to every day now?
I think so. They keep flip-flopping.
I know. They have no money. They're going to run out. AMC, theirs is a little bit different. So you can see up to 3 movies a week.
Okay.
So it's not as many movies. However, where things are different is IMAX movies count, 3D movies count. Both of those are not on the movie pass. And you can see multiple movies per day and repeat visits of movies you've already seen. So if you just want to watch three movies in a row, you can do that.
Yeah.
If you want to watch Avengers three times, you can do that, which those you can't do with
AMC,
the movie pass.
They have to do something because they're losing The Walking Dead. So they're saying, like, hey, we're still here, even though we don't have our
They've
signature
show.
They've
not lost The Walking Dead yet. It's just it's no good anymore.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's still there, Monica.
It's there, but it's really gone.
It's like Grey's Anatomy. It's still there. Yeah. Somebody's watching.
Barely. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Number two,
also still there, that volcano.
Yeah.
We haven't really been talking about it.
What are we going to do? There's nothing you can do. That's Mother Nature.
No, we're going to sit and wait, and I guess eventually it stops. I don't know.
When?
The one in Hawaii or Guatemala?
No, the one in Hawaii.
Hawaii's still going?
How much lava you got?
It's been going since May 3rd. It is now covers 6,000 acres, so that's 9.5 square miles of the island. And I bring this up because now idiots are getting arrested and fined $5,000 because they're going into lava zone areas that are closed off to the public for your own safety to take pictures to hopefully have them go viral on social media.
How about put signs up that you go in, walk in at your own risk.
We're going to push you into the lava and that's okay.
I mean, if you see fiery burning lava there on the ground, why would you want to go close to it anyway?
We can't save your toe.
Inhaling that stuff is not good for you.
That is also correct.
Right?
That's why they set up these things.
That's so stupid. Just to go viral? Oh, do it for the gram.
Well, Mount Everest, they tell you, you're probably going to die. You know, but people still, I'm going to climb Mount Everest. Okay, well,
you want to go into Guinness Book of World Records so bad?
Don't call us.
All right.
Mount Everest is morbidly hilarious because I've watched some documentaries on it because it's very interesting. But if you do unfortunately die, there's nothing they can do about it.
No.
Because you're on this narrow trail and it's too difficult to take you down.
Yep.
So they push you off to the side of the trail and that's where you lay.
That's it.
Mm-hmm. That's crazy, man.
It's insane.
But you decided to climb.
But hey, you did. You accept that risk.
Yeah.
That is what it is.
Number one,
finally, the marriage we've all been waiting for between pizza and pure laziness. This pizza box is genius.
Oh.
It will make you feel ashamed of yourself while you use it, but that's okay. Well, you know how when you open a pizza box, you have both sides. So this one has little cardboardy things on the top and the bottom, so it becomes a little cardboard table so you can sit in bed and eat pizza.
No!
Yes!
Pizza in bed!
Pizza in bed, Monica!
It's a dream come true.
No, the only table I like is that little table they used to put in the center of the pizza. That little tiny table.
Oh, the little patio table.
Yeah, that was for
the top didn't press down on your cheese and all the cheese got stuck to the box.
I never knew what it was for. I always thought it was just a little tabletop thing, too.
I was using it for my dollhouse, no. But,
it's to give your Shopkins some pizza. You didn't know it was part of the big Pizza Hut Shopkins promotion, huh?
We got a collab going.
But yeah, this one's great. It's a tray table for your pizza.
Yeah, you do feel bad, though, when you're laying there like, I got
Oh, my
pizza
God. Monica, when you were pregnant and you would go to 7 different fast food places them all out on your bed. You could have used this table.
I was pregnant. I can use that excuse.
Table was here to help a pregnant woman gain 100 pounds.
So.
get this pizza bed table thing?
That's a pizza company called Boston Pizza, which, of course, is not in Boston, but in Canada. So.
Oh.
If you're up there getting your recreational substances
it is now
legal there. Uh-huh. Oh my God, this is a godsend.
Oh my gosh, right on top.
Marketing genius up
Look
there.
Look at that.
Good Lord.
That's crazy.
But it's an easy enough idea. You could probably hack it yourself sort of add some little cardboardy things on
Look
there.
That up.
Brand new birthday scam is next on the radio. Pizza problems.
Hey-o.
Look at that. And we're going to play Name That Tune on the K92 Mornin Thang Facebook live feed. So if you want to watch that go down, I picked out some forgotten gems. Actually, some of them are kind of crap, but they're forgotten songs from the last couple years. So we'll get into that. That's on the podcast thing and the Facebook live feed or the birthday scam on the radio pizza problems next on the thing. Hi, person who's going to get the winner, jerk.
Really?
No, we got the winner.
Ha ha!
Wait, really?
No. Which one? There's only two numbers left, and I was...
William's funny. He won the prize. He's like, that's cool.
But he's moving, right?
He doesn't know what it is.
Oh.
But even William. Though he
Monster
really
Truck?
Good.
This.
Monster Truck Show. Liz!
Hey. Hey.
What up?
Okay.
Oh.
That's all right. We do have Facebook.
Yeah, you're live here, so all your questions can be directed to, 11 different people that are on Facebook as well. But just so you know. Yeah.
Oh, yeah, it's on.
Yeah, no, they're listening, so, don't divulge any of your spy secrets.
She's not on the mic. So.
True. Also true.
Okay. What's up?
Anyway, go ahead.
Okay. Cool.
Cool.
Sounds good to me.
Yeah, well, we'll
I feel like we're putting you out.
No, no, you're good. But let's. I do want to look it over. So let me. We'll come to you at like 9:50. Okay. Okay. Cool. Yeah. Yep. Perfect.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay. I need to name that tune.
Watch out for that wall.
I need to disable this. I need to disable that. Okay. Got that.
Yeah.
Turn that off.
Can you like be happy or something?
We
left the winner for you.
I know.
I am
even
happy.
Though you broke the desk.
That was you. Don't even.
You broke the desk.
No, it was
Brad
you.
He broke it.
You broke the desk. Wow.
Slid right on out.
You want all the smoke, huh?
Today I want too? All the smoke.
carry you over to today. All the smoke. Bring it.
All the smoke.
You want all the smoke.
I called Freddie. He's like, that's a lot of, what did you say? Huh? Why is there so much hostility on my face?
Oh, yeah. Because you were like asking me about
the way you said it was so funny.
Put the teases in yet? No. Why not? Yesterday, you ain't put it in on my whole show.
All right.
Whoa.
Here we go. Let me get this started. Put this here.
Talk to the hand. Not home.
Talk to the hand. What is this? 1993?
Talk to the hand because the face not home. Leave a message at the beat.
I had one girl tell me at the laundromat. She said, talk to the white because the black's not trying to hear it. At the laundromat. And I still remember that.
At the laundromat.
At the laundromat. Long time ago.
Why was she doing that to you? Was she a friend of yours?
No, I didn't know who she was.
And Monica stuffed her in a washing machine and turned it on. So we never saw her again. Very clean dead body that they came across later on. Here we go.
Any song, any genre, any time period. It's time to play
Name That Tune.
The battle of musical knowledge.
Ladies don't seem very excited today.
They keep losing to Fred in this game.
It's getting old.
That's KT right there. It is getting old.
Then make it
new. We got to win. We got
to
win it.
I'm trying to win, but you know, sometimes it's kind of hard when somebody always buzzes in all fast.
Well, that's the game. You got to buzz
in. I'm trying, but then Zach always favors Freddie, and I'm like, you know what? Forget it.
Not true. You've had your opportunities, and you've dropped the ball lots of times.
He's whatever. Right. I'm not rude.
Where is Lil Uzi Vert?
I'm rolling my eyes.
Know, where is Lil Uzi Vert?
There's a new freezer.
I need. We need to do an edition of this game where it's all people whose
all
names
music.
Start with Lil.
Lil.
No, that'd be awful.
Please.
Name every Lil tune, and I believe KT would clean up
Lil
in this
Yachty,
affair.
Lil Yachty, I wouldn't know. I would not know.
Lil Yachty.
I would just lose. Lil Blue.
Lil Yachty.
I don't know.
Or as someone who used to work here called her, what was it, Lil Yachty?
Take
us to the Lil Yachty show.
Lil Yachty. Yeah. I said, who?
Yeah, we had to force her to retire because she sounded 1 million years old.
Get out of here.
Okay, so it's any genre, any time period, any of that stuff. I kind of dug up a few forgotten gems of the last few years. And by gems, I don't necessarily mean good, but just forgotten. Maybe there was a reason we tried to forget a few of them. So the way Name That Tune works is you buzz in with your name and you know the answer. And if you get it right, you get a point for the artist or any of the artists, and then you get a point for the title of the song. -1 if you get it all wrong. The top two move on to final Name That Tune, where they bid back and forth on one remaining song. Are we ready to roll here?
Ready to roll.
Okay, let's see. We got KT, we've got Monica, and we've got Freddie Mac ready to play in the game. Everybody, name this tune.
Fred.
That is Fred first.
Shoot, I'm thinking of this freaking, man.
3 seconds.
I don't want to be a player no more.
Two,
I'm not a player no more.
One.
Fat Joe.
Zero. I'm sorry, that is -1 for you. -1 on all of those guesses there. Monica Brooks.
That is Big Pun. Punisher. I don't know the title.
Okay.
That's Big Pun.
That is 1 point for you.
I said Big Pun? No.
You said it after I said over with, so no. It didn't matter. That's a point for Monica. Now, KT, there is still a title and one more artist. If you would like to buzz in on this throwback song.
I would like to not buzz in.
Okay.
She don't know it.
Sorry. That is Still Not a Playa is the name of the song, and that is Big Pun featuring Joe. That is Joe.
Oh, Joe.
Yep, Joe.
Stutter.
Sorry. So that is 1 point for you, Monica. KT, you're in second place. Top two move on to final Name That Tune with 0. And Freddie Mac, you have -1. We move on now to song 2.
Name this tune.
Oh,
Monica.
That is Macklemore.
Kayla.
3 seconds.
It's Poppin' Tags.
No, that's Fred. One Kayla, point for you, no, Kayla. She buzzed in first. KT.
I wanna pop some. It's called a thrift shop store, something like that.
Which one?
What is it?
Thrift shop.
Thrift shop is correct. That is correct.
Okay.
Can I get a point from Ryan Lewis?
He's not a list. Well, actually,
is he listed? Yeah.
I don't know.
I thought he was on a whole album. I don't know.
Yeah, you know what? I think you can. You can. Okay. Yeah, I'm going to say yes on that. He is listed.
Thrift store.
He is listed.
he is a listed artist.
Don't make me come over there.
So I'll do that one too. So that's a point for everyone. Okay. Got a point on that one. Oh, and just as a refresher, so you know, is if someone is guessing and you want to buzz in second, you wait. When I say 3 seconds is when you buzz.
Okay.
Oh,
yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Just,
we just get
to be
excited.
Clear on that. So, anyway. Mm-hmm. So now that means Monica, you have 2. Kayla, you have 1. Freddie Mac, you have 0. Name this tune.
Kayla.
KT first.
What?
That was KT first.
On a something trying to hit for his role. She's married to the money. It is.
Oh, 3 seconds.
Fred.
What is it
called? Wait 3 seconds.
He beat you on that one. 3 seconds. 2, 1. I'm sorry. That is minus 1 for you. Fred buzzed in.
No, I was already buzzing.
The other time he said 3 seconds.
When I said 3 seconds, you weren't paying attention. He buzzed in. I know.
Can I just have another chance?
I'm sorry. You got a minus 1. Freddie Mac, go.
Fetty Wap, Trap Queen.
Damn
is
it.
Correct. Yes.
You had it.
Yeah, you did.
I know. I just couldn't think. I'm so sad.
1738. Hey. I forgot about this song.
I'm like, hey, what's up, hello?
Hey, 92 played that.
Oh, yeah.
A lot.
A lot. Yeah.
Too much.
He really is married to the money. Oh, yeah. He has like 10 baby mamas right now.
What?
You should have had that one, girl.
I know.
Oh, man.
You are the trap queen.
I know.
I put it out there for you.
What the hell?
Wow. So that was your song right there.
Yeah. I was blank. Under pressure.
Takashi, right. 69.
Drop
right
the
now.
Ball.
Monica 2.
That's true.
Freddie Mac 2. KT 0. Song 4. Let me see. Okay. Yeah, this is song 4. There's possible 2 points on this one. Go ahead and name this.
You, Kayla. It was Kayla.
No, it was Monica. It was
that's
Monica.
Soulja Boy.
With
Soulja Boy, tell him.
No, that's 1 point for you. Anybody else like to buzz in? Anybody else like to buzz in? Freddie Mac.
Crank that.
Soulja Boy, tell
him. That is correct.
Yeah, I got this new guy up. Yeah,
I'm trying to Soulja Boy with Soulja Boy, tell him.
The song is Soulja Boy, tell them.
Soulja Boy anthem. Soulja Boy singing songs with Soulja Boy, featuring Soulja Boy.
Right.
Oh, yeah. It's Joy Fred's wedding.
Superman.
Featuring Soulja Boy. Backing vocals by Soulja Boy.
Yeah. But I think that's part of the title. Soulja
no,
Boy
it's not. That's his whole name. Soulja Boy Tell Him.
I thought Soulja Boy Tell Him was in the title.
No.
Okay,
nope.
We're fine.
Nope.
Minus 2.
Right. Crank That is the name of the song. Monica, you have 3. Fred, you have 3. You're all tied up. KT, you have 0.
How do I have 0?
You got 1 and then you lost it. Now, there's a possible 4 points on this one. Okay? So you could launch into first place.
Okay.
If you are lucky. Mm-hmm. Here we go. Name this tune.
Kayla.
KT.
I said I like it like that. Cardi B. It is.
And who else? You have 2 more artists.
Oh, I don't.
You need them to tie it up.
Cardi B. I don't.
3 seconds.
Come on.
Okay. But, 2. Oh. 1. I'm sorry, you're done. Monica, there are other artists. If you get it, you'll go into first place.
J-Lo.
That is.
That's not it.
Minus 1 for Monica.
I love how she's so serious.
She was so confident.
I can't think of any other artists out.
You don't have to, because you'll actually launch yourself into the finals, but Monica has actually fallen into a tie with KT, so I have to do a tiebreaker. This is I Like It Like That, Cardi B, Bad Bunny, and J Balvin, not J Lo. J Balvin.
So I got 2 points, right?
Yes.
Okay.
I said J Bo, though.
Yeah, no, you didn't.
I know
J-Lo.
I did.
You were so confident with that, J Lo.
J Lo.
You said J No. Okay. Sorry. Freddie Mac, you're into the finals, but I have to play another one for these other 2. So go ahead. This is Monica and KT. Name this tune.
Kayla.
That is Monica first.
Oh.
It was close, but that's Monica.
I drew a blank.
3 seconds. And you don't
it's,
have 2.
Is that sort of a
Zero. I'm sorry. Crap. That is minus one, and you go into the hole. That was a terrific failure right there.
No, it was.
This is Camila Cabello. Never be the same.
Yeah.
And KT's going to the finals now.
Wow. Yes.
Okay, so we're done.
I love when y'all
start to sing the song.
And then you do it poorly. Anyway, let's move on now. The final name that too.
You gotta win.
Let's go, Frederick.
Frederick versus
Kayla.
Here we go. Name that too.
KT.
That's right. K-Basimo. We'll give you your full one. And see, Ariel on Facebook, she had all of them. She knew. J Belvin, whatever it is. Okay, we're into the finals. Now, Fred, you'll start the bidding. You'll go back and forth on how much time you need. You can do it in seconds. You can also do it in the blamp, which is 0.25 seconds. You can do it in the super blamp, 1/10 of a second. Or you can just do it on this clue. The clue today, hip, hip, hooray.
Hip, hip, hooray.
Hip, hip, hooray.
Oh, I know it.
Freddie Mac.
No, you don't. Sit down.
Write it down there, Stain, if you want to. Freddie Mac, how much time do you need?
I can name that tune in 2 seconds, KT.
2 seconds.
I can name it in one.
One. Ooh.
I can name it in a super blamp.
Super blamp, 1/10 of a second. Or do you want to just go on the clue? Hip, hip, hooray.
Name that tune.
Okay. Freddie Mac will name this tune. You will hear the super blamp, 1/10 of a second. 2 times, and then you must give me an answer.
I meant to say blamp, but oh well.
Freddie Mac, name this tune.
I already know what it is.
One more time. You ready?
Man.
Shh, shh, shh. Not that. Who the beat was that?
That was my beat.
Damn phone.
Cheaters, right. Man. Shh, shh, shh. I love to cheat.
They do love to cheat.
Ow.
Shh. Okay, ready? There it is. That's your super blamp right there. I don't know if any of the other Stains in the room have a guess, but Fred will think for a second while he tries to figure it out. Clue, hip, hip, hooray.
Oh.
I gotta start putting some victory music in this system here. Okay. Freddie Mac. Name that tune.
The artist is Omi. The song is Cheerleader. Give me that trophy!
Yeah.
What's this say? Fun
found me a millionaire.
Oh, found
he says
me a millionaire.
That or something.
Omi, cheerleader. Found me a find me. I thought it said find me a millennial. What Monica wrote on this? Look at this. Find
what?
Me a millennial.
It looks
right
like
there.
Millennial.
What is that? Freddie Mac says Omi cheerleader. He is correct. That is the victory. I know. I need some victory
What'd
music
you have,
here.
Katie?
I had Timber by Kesha.
Oh.
Sorry,
it's
not Pitbull. That.
Again, that was a few weeks ago. She said Kesha instead of Pitbull.
Yeah, we did that song. Yep, there it is. Hip, hip, hooray, cheerleader.
Found
hip,
me
hooray.
A millionaire.
No, we don't do that.
Find me a millionaire.
Find me a millennial. Pump me down a dang
I'm
millennial.
I'm so sad.
Freddie Mac wins again, undefeated in this game. It was very close.
It was close, though.
You blew it, Trap Queen.
Man.
I set you up for it
I
and
know.
Everything. You know, and I will confess, I tried to put Lil Yachty in this one, but we've already deleted it from the system. That's how bad that song was.
Terrible.
Couldn't have it in here. We still have Fetty Wap.
I'll get him next week.
Next week. We'll see what I can put in there. Name that tune champion, undefeated, yet again, Freddie Mac.
Yeah, my God, you had it.
Whatever.
What would be great though?
Good
really,
game.
Really good, but also probably crazy. Bob versus Zach.
I mean, I used to play against Bob all the time,
and it was very intense.
All right, see y'all. In a bit.
Thank you. So close. Thought you had it. Thought you had worked your way back in.
J-Lo.
That is J-Lo.
No, it is not. It's actually a man. I said J-Balo. J-Balo.
So much certainty. Like, just, I know this.
I'm assuming.
No, I do.
I'm going to go with Alex's. Yes, there it is. There's his folder. I knew there'd be a folder in there. Okay, let's see. We can. Y'all have a great day. We are here for Friday tomorrow. Hooray. Oh, yeah. See, that would be too easy, though, Brandon. I couldn't do that. But Ruth, yeah. Look at that. See, Ruth knew.
What would be too
Good
easy?
Job, Ruth. that hip hop hooray.
Oh, OPP?
The, yeah.
I mean,
hip, hip, no,
Naughty
the
by
song
Nature?
Hip hop hooray, yeah.
Oh, the song, not yeah, by Naughty by Nature.